Everybody come see the greatest show. Gather up all juggalos and roll. Everybody come see the greatest show.
Spy Report. Radio Insider.
I guess. I'm working, Dan. I don't give the tongue at work.
Buddies.
Good evening, buddies.
It is the Ron and Fez show. Happy Passover.
Passover begins. I've got some lamb's blood painted over my door.
All right,
Fezzy. Everything should be fine.
The phones are already blowing up with a...
Spy report. Spy report. Spy report.
Yes, we know Dudley Moore died today, Fezzy, but we got one more.
One more besides Dudley Moore?
Spy report.
There you go. I'll let Donovan tell the story. Donovan, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Card holder, 8098.
Spy report.
Just saw ABC News. Milton Berle just died.
Milton Berle is gone, Fezzy.
The first comedian to be on television.
Uncle Milty first to be on television? I know he had that show when very few people did, but I don't know.
I know he was Mr. Television.
Right.
And Mr. Tuesday Night.
Yeah.
And Rob Van Dam stole that gimmick.
All right, so Milton Berle gone.
Spy report.
See ya.
Yeah, The Undertaker was on TV already, Fezzy, and said they'd need an extra 10 inches at the bottom of the coffin.
Wow.
Uncle Milty, big, big man.
Yes.
Big, big man.
Notoriously hung.
Yeah.
Very well endowed. Oh, that's sad about Uncle Milty.
All right, first Dudley Moore, then Milton Berle. Who's next, Fezzy, because they come in threes.
Threes? Are we sticking with comedians?
Yeah, it's got to be a third comedian. So it's not really good news for Buddy Hackett, you got to figure.
No, uh-uh.
Somebody along those lines have got a Jackie Mason has got to be checking his own pulse.
Jack Carter. Make an appointment with the doctor.
Norm Crosby is saying, how do I look?
Phyllis Diller.
Don Geronimo. Oh, nah, it was a false report.
Right. False. Fake.
Spy report. Radio Insider. Spy report. Radio Insider.
That was fake. He's alive and well and doing good.
So definitely these things coming in threes.
Coming in threes now.
So you got to figure out who's the third.
I mean, how about this? Billy Staples.
I've been taking that bet for a year now.
That's easy money. I mean, you can't even get odds on it. Vegas is taking it off the board.
It's a push.
It's a push at this point.
It's a push into the bar. Yeah. That's what it is.
All right, here's another...
Spy report.
Hey, Steve, you're on the Ron and Fez radio show.
Hey, Steve.
Hey, what's up?
Hey, buddy.
Listen, your third guy is Randy Castillo from Ozzy's band.
Yeah, I know, but he's not exactly part of that whole group, but that's sad news. How did he die? He was a drummer, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, later.
I think he got hit with a ham when they threw it over the wall last night.
Hey, John, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, John.
Hey, how's it going, Ron and Fez?
Yeah.
3577.
All right, buddy.
You know, after today's performance, I think it's going to be Rich Voss that gets it at his next show by some black man.
I don't think so, because you have to be a comedian to be in this. Come on, that's not fair.
You got a point there, Ronnie.
All right, thanks.
Let's just hope it's not any of you guys, all right?
And Rich Voss dies every weekend.
Oh, please. We love Richie. That's pretty, Hey, Matt, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Matt.
Hey, guys.
Hey,
buddy. I think it's got to be Bob Hope.
Bob Hope, that's got to be even money on that.
Wow.
When's the last time they even brought him out into the yard?
He's got to be, over 100 now, right?
Reagan gets out more than Bob Hope.
Yeah, Bob Hope, they dragged him out for something. I think he did like a Bob Hope library section in Washington.
Really? Like
that,
he read.
That he waved at.
Right. All right. Bob Hope, good possibility there. You got to say the odds on Bob Hope got to be like 2-1.
Bob Hope leading the pack.
Maybe even. 1-1. Hey, Sean. Sean, we're looking for the next dead comedian.
Carrot Top got killed.
Oh, Carrot Top, please. Carrot Top will live forever. That's the problem there.
Hey, only the good die young. At 93 today, Milton Berle.
Hey, John, you're on the fence.
Guys, buddy.
Yeah, buddy.
Here it is. Yeah. The whole Seinfeld cast.
Oh, that's not fair.
Oh, they suck. They're horrible. They have to die.
You know, they've gone through a rough year. The third show got pushed, now, I think.
But I think this one goes in sixes, because they all suck.
Oh, Jesus People are so cruel. There's a cruelness out there, Fezzy.
That is a bad show.
James, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, James.
Hey, guys, how you doing?
Yeah.
All right, it's got to be Richard Pryor. That guy's going any day now.
Well, Richard Pryor not
he's
looking...
Can't be in good health.
Yeah, he's all shaky and whatnot.
Yeah. Yeah, he's not looking good.
All right, not a bad pick, James. 877-692-1027.
Jeff, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, Jeff.
I'm Calvin.
How you doing?
Hey, what's going on?
Yeah, how you doing, man?
Good. How about Jackie Martling?
I hear when these things come in threes. Jackie jumped off a stack of his own CDs to his death.
Oh, no.
Thanks, Jeff.
Thank you.
Hey, Mike, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, Mike.
Hi. Yeah. Hi, guys. Listen, can I get 100 on Tony Randall?
Tony Randall?
I think he just had another baby this afternoon, so he's doing fine.
God.
All right, thanks.
That's what I mean. Can I get 100 on him? God knows when he's going to go.
That's so awful.
Those kids will never know their grandparents.
Hey, Matt, you're on a Fez.
Hey, Matt.
Hey, yeah, the next guy that's going to be gone, Jerry Lewis.
Oh, jeez.
His last telethon, he looked like he was on his way out.
He doesn't look good. He's shaky and... For whatever reason, has an extra big head.
Jerry Lewis...
He looks like he's got the disease.
Yeah, he doesn't... Yeah, he might have caught it.
Constantly in the hospital with something.
Well, the problem is he's been hanging around his kids for so long, Fezzy.
Oh, you know, and they say it's not contagious.
Yeah.
Yeah, right.
I'm now thinking that he's the carrier.
He's Typhoid Jerry.
Yeah, it's just awful. Joe, you're on Run of Fez.
That's why I won't push a wheelchair. Hi, Joe.
Hi, how are you? I think it'd be Rodney Dangerfield.
Good one.
Yeah, they cracked his chest open.
Yeah, looking old.
Yeah, just had his heart problems. Yeah. Heart attack and surgery.
I saw a picture of him with no shirt on not too long ago. Not kidding, Rolling Stone. And just big crack across his chest.
Nice, showing it off where Letterman won't.
Yeah. All right, here's the, off the Metro Source, the TV pioneer and legendary comedian, Milton Berle, dead, 92 years old. I thought he was older. He died in his sleep at his home. One of TV's first major stars. And to me, Fezzy, I never thought I laughed once.
Really?
Yeah.
I loved Milton Berle when I was a kid.
What was funny about him?
I think the dress.
Yeah.
Texaco Star Theater. We are the men from Texaco. We work from Maine to Mexico.
I don't even remember that show. I got to tell you the truth. I mean, I've seen it in the clips and all, but I don't remember what was on TV. Anthony, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, Anthony.
What's up Run of Fez? Big ass card 13505.
All right.
Hoo-ah, hoo-ah.
All right, yeah, buddy.
This one makes me a little upset to say. I don't want to say it, but Mr. George Carlin is getting up there in age.
George has looked the same, though, for like 30 years.
Yeah, but I mean... The last HBO special, he was looking, I mean, he's not to say he looks bad, but he's looking very old.
Yeah.
He's in his 60s.
But I know, he's in his 60s, but he has got to be 30 years younger than a lot of the people we're talking about, with those Jackie Masons and all that.
George always looked nice and lanky and healthy that way, like a runner's body.
Yeah, but you know, he's had heart attacks. He's had two heart attacks.
Yeah, that's true.
Here's Larry. Larry, you're on runner. Can't say that, Larry.
877-692-1027.
Andrew, you're on Run
of
Fez.
Hey, what's up? Big ass card member, 1810.
Hoo-hoo-hoo-ah!
Hey, what about Gene Wilder? Since he's sick.
Was he sick?
Yeah, he's got some sort of cancerous thing.
Oh, jeez. I came from hanging out at that Gilda's place.
Yeah.
Yeah, be careful where you hang, ladies and gentlemen.
Just be so careful with the charity work. It's good, it's, you know, people need it, but, man, wear a mask, something.
Hey, Greg, you're on Run of Fez.
Hi, Greg.
Hey there, guys. Yeah, hey, we're looking at Johnny Carson. He's not looking too good either.
I haven't seen him in forever. I haven't seen him since the night he walked off the stage.
I saw him, and they got a snapshot of him at the grocery store with his wife in one of the tabloids.
How's he look?
A little heavier, but that's about it.
Yeah.
Still looks like Johnny.
It's
the one with Chelsea Clinton just tonguing her boyfriend on the cover. I think it's the Globe.
What do you do, read these things?
When I see Chelsea Clinton giving someone the tongue on the cover, I'm going to buy the magazine.
All right, we'll bring it in with you tomorrow, because I want to see what Johnny looks like. Hey, Matt, you're on Run of Fez. Death comes in threes. We lost Dudley Moore, Milton Berle, and now who's next?
Hey, Matt.
Hello, boys.
Yeah.
Hey, I think it's going to be Jim Norton. I think his age is going to flare up.
Oh, please. I hope not. Oh, I pray for that poor kid. John, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, guys.
I think it's got to be Bobcat Goldthwait. I'm going with the law of averages. I mean, he gets to bang Nicky Cox. God has to strike him dead.
And, you know, he looks not all that well. He lost an enormous amount of weight.
And is that supposed to be a health program? No, I don't think so.
No, not when you look like that. You look unwell. Hey, Joe, you're on Ron of Fez. How you doing?
Hey, Joe.
Hey, guys. Hey, I think the next one to go is going to definitely be Rosie O'Donnell.
Rosie's going to live for a long time.
Well, hey, listen, she's been in the press a lot with all this coming out, and she's a bull dyke, right?
Yeah.
So somebody's going to realize, hey, I put my kid up for adoption, and she adopted my kid, and she's a bull dyke. So they're going to go over there, and they're going to, like, take knives and plunge them into her body and, like, cut off her boobs and wear them as a party hat.
Oh, I don't see that at all, but thank you for being so descriptive.
It would be weird if that's how the third one came in.
All right, Mike. Mike, you're on Ron of Fez. How you doing, buddy?
Hello, Mike.
Hey, guys.
Yeah.
I'm praying Dice is going to go.
That's fun.
You know, if someone says they're praying for Dice, it should be in a good way.
Right.
Not to leave this mortar coil.
Hey, Scott, you're on Ron of Fez.
Hey, Scott.
10052. How you doing, buddies?
Yeah, buddy.
How about Bruce Valanche? I'm hoping.
You know, Fezzy, as they, then the joke will be, God said, get me Bruce Valanche.
God needed a gag writer.
Right. Gag writer is a right word for those jokes. So, it's very sad, Fezzy.
If Bruce Valanche went, Whoopi would just have to kill herself.
Please. She should anyway.
What if she had fallen off that trapeze at the Oscars? Pulled an Owen.
I was. Now, where is there a God, Fezzy? There can't be one. If he's dropping Owen Wilson and letting...
Owen Hart.
Owen Hart. Yeah, Owen Wilson was fine. He's dropping Owen Hart, and he's letting Whoopi come sliding down like there's no tomorrow.
And Whoopi lands safely.
Yeah.
877-692-1027.
Dudley Moore, that was a sad one also, huh, Fezzy?
That was really sad.
He's a goner.
Yeah, he's a goner.
This must be awfully embarrassing for you.
It's not embarrassing. Everybody dies. There's a guy who took one, maybe two roles and just got a lifetime of bad work after that.
Right. It's movie 10 and Arthur.
And then that's it.
Yeah. And he is dining out for the rest of his life.
Right. He gets to make 40 bad movies. In the meantime, here in Fez and I are scratching away every single night. So, Dudley Moore, sad day, Fezzy.
It was sad, and, you know, they saw this one coming. He had that degenerative disease, that form of Parkinson's.
Right. So. His family is, and this happened in Jersey, his family's all getting together now.
Right.
The Moore family.
So, our condolences, you know, he died at his home in Jersey, so our home... our condolences to their home and the entire Moore family.
Sure, Roger Moore.
Roger Moore, our condolences go out to you.
I believe Roger Moore was there with him, as well as his sister.
Mary Tyler Moore.
Mary Tyler Moore. His young niece, Mandy Moore, was there. Just a delight, Phil. Just a delight.
Sister-in-law by marriage, Demi Moore.
That's Demi. She wants to be called Demi Moore.
She's
now
back to Demi?
Yeah, she's back to Demi. And I heard that from the other sister, Julianne Moore.
Oh.
They were all with Dudley Moore
when
he passed.
The entire Moore family, our condolences tonight. Yeah. Chris Moore from Project Greenlight.
The redheaded one? Chris Moore was there?
Yes.
He's part of that family?
Right, yeah.
I know Melba Moore was devastated.
Sure. Yeah. She's in seclusion right now. Yeah. Along with Jay Moore.
Jay Moore?
Yes.
That's a different spelling.
Yeah, still related, though.
Wow.
It's the odd thing.
He's a nephew.
Yeah.
I know everybody at Benjamin Moore Paints.
Right, yeah.
I don't know whether they're open today. I have no idea.
You might want to check if you're going for paints and other home improvement supplies. You might want to check. Make sure they are open. Michael Moore, who writes those lousy books and makes those horrible films.
See the kind of fat guy?
The fat guy, yeah. With the baseball cap.
He was devastated. He was sobbing.
Right.
Ah, he lost Dudley Moore, his brother.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Herman Moore, I think receiver for the Lions.
Right.
Is that right? Yeah.
And now Dave Moore.
He's flying in.
Yeah, Dave Moore from the, I think he's with the Bills now.
Right, left the Buccaneers.
Yeah.
Yeah. The devastating loss is just for the Moore family. I remember when they lost Clayton Moore.
Right, the Lone Ranger.
Yeah.
He'll be buried next to him.
Really?
And Gary Moore.
Oh, Gary Moore from To Tell the Truth.
Right.
And Gary Moore Show.
I think Dudley is going to be buried between the two. I think that was his parents.
Okay.
Yeah. So it's sad. Everything, it goes out to the Moore family. Just wonderful people.
Yeah, Sam Moore. You know him from Sam and Dave.
Yeah, Sam Moore, terrific. Nat Moore from the Dolphins. I feel awful about that.
Right. Of course, Drew Barrymore.
Drew Barrymore is part of that family?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
And her husband, Tom Sizemore.
Uh-huh,
it's
yeah.
just the Moore family. Everybody from Jane Seymour.
Right. Dudley Moore's aunt.
Right.
Yeah. Alanis Morissette.
She's writing an angry song about it.
Yeah. Oh, she will.
She added the Asette to the end of the Moore name.
Yeah, and then weird, I guess, stage name. Tracy Morgan.
Right.
From Saturday Night Live.
Morgan Fairchild.
Uh-huh. Morrissey.
He doesn't have sectional.
Really?
Doesn't like it.
Wow.
So it's sad.
Yeah. The Moors, who, of course, invaded Spain.
Yeah, he's got that Moore blood in him, doesn't he?
Yes, exactly. Maybe that's what did it.
Yeah.
We're not sure.
Hey, Orlando. Orlando, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Orlando.
Yeah. Yo, what's up? I heard the people at a Dinty Moore beef store are very devastated as well.
I understand he owned part of that.
Yeah.
Dudley Moore. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
At one point...
he said add carrots.
That was his?
That was his innovation.
Wow.
Yeah. So we send our condolences out there.
The Moore family.
Yeah. Morgan Fairchild.
She's in that family?
Yeah, she's part of the Moore family.
I didn't think so because she was so blonde.
Yeah, isn't that where? I think it's a bleach or a dye.
Yeah. Agnes Moorehead.
All right, yeah.
Which I guess she married a guy named Head.
Yeah.
But, you know, Agnes Moorehead.
Went on to found Moorehead State University.
Yeah.
We grieve for those people.
Joe, you're on Manifest.
Hey, Joe.
Hey, I understand he was holding Mary Tyler Moore's hand when he passed.
Yeah, we brought that up earlier.
Yeah, and he's going to be married next. He's going to be buried next to Jim Morrison.
Morrison, yeah.
Right,
yeah,
that's true.
I know Van Morrison was in shock.
Awfully upset.
Yeah. The Moore family, a terrific bunch of people, Fezzy. And that little Mandy Moore, I think she's going to be the best of the whole lot.
Well, she's got a lot of potential there.
She does.
I loved her in the Black Cinderella. That was good.
I didn't see it, but
I guess it was just her that was black. Other people were white in it. But
it's just great. Hey, Tony, you're around the fest.
Hi, Tony.
Yeah, I heard the whole Mormon Tabernacle Choir is upset.
Nice.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. The Moors mourn.
Yeah.
Tonight. That's very sad.
More bad news is, I hope the Postal say tomorrow. Mm-hmm. No, will he get pushed out of the way from Milton Berle?
Yeah, that's the really rough thing.
Yeah, it is. It's awful.
So, I mean, you die and you think, all right, I'm at least going to have the headlines.
Right.
When a few hours later, someone probably a little bit more famous.
More famous. I
more.
Get yeah, I get
famous.
It. Hey, Warren.
You're forgetting about his distant cousin, the prostitute.
All right, you're, you're laughing about this, but we lost,
Yeah.
We lost, a very big little man.
Mm-hmm. As he called himself, the sex thimble.
Joe Morgan on the SF feedback.
Oh, yeah.
I guess is the, like they said, everybody, has got one in the woodshed, Fezzy.
Sure. Morgan Freeman.
Yeah.
Yeah. Some people have more. The one in the woodshed.
And they do.
Yeah.
Hey, Sean. Sean, you're on the Fez.
Hey, guys. The little kid from Oliver. Please, sir. More. He's going to be at the bedside.
That's odd.
Yeah, really?
Can I have some more? Please?
Some more.
Yeah.
Okay. So Oliver will actually be there.
Yeah.
877-692-1027.
Hey, Mark. Mark, you're on the Fez.
Listen, I heard that Morris the cat was there as well.
Hmm. I didn't know that.
Right, his pet.
Morris the cat.
Yeah.
Yes, we know.
We got you.
We're with you.
Hey, Jeff. Jeff, you're on the Fez.
Yeah, I heard the pairing, Mork and Mindy.
Mork and Mindy. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. So the whole family devastated Fezzy.
That's rough.
You hear their family song, it seems even sadder. This is one that the Moore family, Dudley Moore, Roger Moore, Demi Moore.
I thought it was Demi.
No.
Back again?
Yes, she changed it. Julianne Moore. Noble Moore. Jay Moore.
Yeah.
Who, for whatever reason, changed the spelling.
I guess just to make it on his own.
Yeah.
Change the spelling, but not the pronunciation.
Yeah. Hey, Boogie. Boogie, you're on Run a Fez.
Hey, Boogie.
What's up, dude? I was going to say Roger Moore, but you stole it, so I guess I'm a moron.
I'm
later.
Kidding. Thank you.
877-692-1027.
Justin, you're on Run a Fez.
Hey, what's up, buddies?
And we lost the Moore today.
Yeah, I understand.
We got one
that,
less Moore.
J.P. Morgan is going to close down for the day tomorrow.
Wow. Wow, that would be
yeah,
good.
In remembrance of it.
Oh, nice. That's only right.
Yeah. How do you like it? How do you like it? Dudley Moore.
How do you like it? How do you like it? More. Well, that's sad stuff. Should we go through the Burles or just drop the bit now?
Probably just drop it. Everyone at Milton Stanley will be closed tomorrow.
Gosh! Well, they come in threes, Fuzzy. You got to be careful.
Yeah. So, right now, it's a death watch. We got Dudley Moore and Milton Berle all in one day. Funny people, do not sleep easy tonight, my friends.
So, you don't think Ozzy's drummer gets anybody off the hook?
I don't think so.
Yeah.
Ozzy Osbourne's drummer, it doesn't fill the bill. It doesn't fit it.
Oh, this on the instant feedback from Fatty.
Yeah?
Angry Fatty Hardy, actually. He's going to be buried on the island of Dr. Moreau. So...
where I'm sure they'll spread his ashes.
I heard he spread his ash a few times. Well, you know, he's gone. There's no sense of even bringing up.
Was he still with Susan Anton, or was that over a long time ago?
All right, now, also they're saying that the Dudley brothers are going to be there, but the Dudley boys, but that's a whole different bit. We can't do that.
Devon, Bubba Ray. Spike. Big Dick.
Hey, PJ, you're on Run a Fez.
Hi, PJ.
Big ass card holder, 1332. Hoo-ah! Hey, Captain Morgan will be mixing up all the drinks at the funeral.
Morgan.
Morgan, sure.
Thank you very much, yeah. Mario. Mario, you're on Run a Fez.
Hi, Mario.
How you doing? Don't forget about all his friends in Morristown, New Jersey.
Okay, Mario, did you hear when Fez and I tried to end the bit when we were somewhere towards the middle? I know we weren't at the top.
Right, yeah. We kind of stretched it out just to get to Andrea True Connection
right.
here.
But that was it. The More and More More song, I'm glad to hear again. Hey, Paul.
Hey
Paul.
Up,
yeah.
Rob Moore, receiver for the Cardinals.
Okay, Paul, again, you know, we definitely did stop the bit.
Yeah.
You know, and it's we're going to be moving on. Karen. Karen, you're on Run a Fez.
Hi, Karen.
Hey, guys. Yeah. Biggest card holder, 5878 or whatever.
Hoo-ah, hoo-ah.
All right, buddy.
Thanks, guys. Yeah. Let's put Aaron Moore in.
Okay, Aaron Moore in. All right, we got it, but the...
Joni from Happy Days.
The important thing here, and then also off runfez.net, but the important thing here is the bit has ended.
Right.
We officially ended the bit. We moved on. Greg, you're on Run a Fez.
Hi, Greg.
Hey, how you doing?
Yeah.
The guy from Moorhead Honda in Mount Kisco must be closed today.
Well, we don't know that for sure.
Yeah,
please.
I don't think he is.
Continue to visit Moorhead Honda.
Yeah, and again, when a bit ends, the bit ends, and
right.
then we stop, and we segue into another topic. And
yeah.
That's the awkward area Fez and I are in right now, that we got into something that wasn't really humor. Yeah. It was really... just making a list, really.
Yeah, just listing things. And right now we have 1 foot kind of stuck in that bit.
Right.
And we're trying to step out of it into the next thing we'll be moving on to.
Right. So that's the thing I want to aim towards.
Just please help us make that step.
Make that segue. Mm-hmm. John, you're on Run a Fez.
Yeah, I heard Morpheus from The Matrix couldn't be reached for comment.
Okay.
And on a semi-related note, Burlington Coat Factory will be closed tomorrow.
Because of Milton Berle. That's not the kind of segue we're looking for.
No, not at all. And, and I'm sure Burlington Coat Factory will still be open.
Right. Obviously. Hey, Billy. Billy, you're on Run a Fez.
Hey, Billy.
Hey, guys. How about Morton Downey Jr.?
All right, Billy, do you remember Fez and I saying that the bit was over?
Sure.
Right.
So that means we got to move on. We've got to segue. And we've got to find another topic to get into.
Yeah, we just got to cut the tie. We can't just keep doing that.
Yeah.
Bit.
Yeah. It never really had legs.
No.
It never had legs. It was crawled at best. And now it's painful. It's almost a slide. Hey, Mike. Mike, you're on Run a Fez.
Hey, Mike.
Yeah, I heard Faith No More is playing at the funeral.
Oh, please. Okay. I don't think so.
We really need to move on from this, right, people.
And also, I just want to remind everybody, they have hits.
Mm-hmm.
All you would have those handed to me, and I'd give me a hit. They were big for a while. Here's Paul. Paul, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, Paul.
Yeah.
How's it going?
Yeah.
I heard all the Mormons in Utah and the late Aaron Burr were devastated.
All right. Now you're really stretching, and we're trying to end the bit at this point.
Yeah. And get out of a non-played Faith No More bit. That's the problem now. Now we've got a Faith No More song that wasn't popular at all, and Fez and I are stuck.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, Dave. Dave, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, Dave.
What's up, guys?
Yeah.
I was watching CNN today. They showed his brother, Garrett Morris, on TV. Very, very sad.
I bet.
You're,
yeah,
not helping us.
But you're still keeping us trapped in this.
And also, on a related note, Milton Bradley will not be making any toys tomorrow.
Because of Milton Berle?
Yeah, that's right.
Okay.
It's very, very.
Okay, thank you. Yes. And before anyone calls, yes, Milton the Kellogg's Toaster, all right? We don't need to hear about him grieving from the Pop-Tart commercials. Thank
hey,
you.
John, you're on Manifest.
Hey, how you doing?
Yeah. Hey, John.
Sir Thomas More is going to see them in Utopia. And I'm a moron for not ending this bit.
All right, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
See, I don't think people want to help us, Fez. I think it's
a type of
situation that we're going to be stuck with for a while.
Yeah, they see us caught.
Yeah.
They see us caught in between bits, right, in a horrible segue loop.
That's why doing talk radio is very difficult in this city.
Just so everyone knows.
Most places, the callers, they want to help. They go, the host is in problems. He got into a bit that wasn't very funny. Let's call, change the subject. Not in New York.
Mm-mm.
New York?
No, uh-uh.
New York, they punish you. Hey, Pete, you're on Run of Fez.
Hi, Pete. What do you got for us tonight?
Hi, Ron. Hi, Fez.
Yeah.
Yeah, the whole city of Baltimore is in mourning for Dudley.
Because of Moore, right?
Baltimore.
See ya.
Yeah. Yeah. Let's hope maybe Pete would be the one.
Yeah. Well, he's not.
No, he's just as mean spirited as the others.
Jim, you're on Run of Fez.
Hi, Jim.
Hey, guys. Yeah. How you doing?
Yeah, good.
I just want to let you know all shows across country starring Ann Moore are canceled.
I got to tell you the truth, I'm not familiar with Ann Moore.
Who's Ann Moore?
You know, everyone, Ann Moore.
All right.
Okay. Well, it was written up completely different on the screen.
Like albums and more?
Oh, right. Okay. Yeah, like that show. Mm-hmm.
Like Ed Moore. I'll just change my last name to Moore. Rich. Rich, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, Rich.
Yeah, I have his nephew, Happy Gill, and his Uncle Ken from Sears.
Uh-huh. Ken Moore and Happy Gilmore.
Those two Moores. Right.
That's where we're going with this.
Yeah, and that's, so we've, now we're Sears catalog humor.
And also, at the same time, stuck into a loop of a Faith No More song that wasn't popular at all.
Right.
We're not listening to Epic or any of the other big hits they had.
No.
We're listening to this one.
We're stuck in this. Well, we've gotten stuck twice at this point.
So it doesn't look like we're getting out. Hey, Kevin.
A lot of quicksand.
Hey, yeah, I heard that he's being buried in Ireland on the cliffs of Moore.
Mm.
Huh. Also, Agnes Moorhead's husband's name was Craven.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Yeah, Craven Moorhead. Right.
All right. Now, Ron Fezmark says he'll be more likely to be buried near Mount Rushmore, his homes.
Oh.
He had a home there.
All right.
Finally. Ain't no more. Made the radio.
It's really, really late.
Yeah.
Really late to where it helps us nil at this point.
And, you know, these guys, Johnny, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, Johnny.
What's up, boys? How you doing?
Johnny.
You want me to save you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I forgot what I was going to say anyway. Dean Morgan Stanley is closed tomorrow. I work for them. But,
That's your way to get me out. That's it. That's what you're going to do for us. Hey, Dan. Dan, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, Dan.
Hey, guys.
Yeah.
Guaranteed way to get you out of this bit.
Yeah. Please.
So I'll take a trip to Morocco. Escape from it.
All right. All of Morocco mourns. And isn't it just really Morocco? The way it's pronounced.
Yeah.
You don't actually hit the Moor really hard in Morocco.
You don't?
No.
What about Morocco Mole?
Nope. or Don Morocco. No.
Ryan, you're on the Fez.
Hey, Ryan.
Yeah, hey, how you guys doing? I heard Jim Mora found out about Dudley Moore, and he said, playoffs? You guys are talking about playoffs?
That's a good impression. But Jim Mora is
Jim Mora's been crying for a while.
Yeah.
It's long before Dudley Moore passed.
Sure. John, you're on the Fez.
I heard Morehead State College, they're scheduling classes.
Right. Now everyone's actually repeating.
Yeah.
That's how sad this bit's gotten.
Yeah. It's bad, and it's at the part of the show, Fezzy, where we're trying to capture people for the night. We're trying to say to people, stick with us.
Right.
You're going to have some fun times. You're going to get some good comedy.
This is supposed to be where we grab them by the lapels and get their attention.
Right.
And we're just stuck.
Yeah, we're floundering. Tom, you're on Ron and Fez?
Hello, Tom.
How you doing, Ron and Fez? Hold a 7614.
That's nice to talk.
I think the headline tomorrow is going to be No More Suffering.
Okay, no more suffering.
No more. Two O's and more.
Suffer no more.
Yeah. Thank you.
I don't know what to say, Fezzy. I mean, we beg no more, no more.
Right.
Please, no more.
And all we got was more. We got more mores.
We got more. Sad, really. It's sad.
Well, you think you build a relationship with an audience, and you think you can depend on them. Sure. You maybe lean on them every once and again when you need to.
Hey, Susan.
Hey, how you doing?
Yeah. Hi, Susan.
I just want to say, more pork sausages, Ma, please. See ya.
No more Jello for me, Ma. It's sad, though, Fezzy.
It's sad. It's sad when you rely, when you reach out
for
help.
And that shouldn't even be our story. The story is we lost Dudley Moore.
Mm-hmm.
Today. It was a very witty man at one time. Mm. Before he got big.
And then we found out we lost Milton Berle.
Yeah. Which no one seems to care about. They're stuck in the more bits.
Yeah.
Steve.
Hi, Steve.
Hey, guys. In a twist of irony, Donnie Moore, who blew his head off after a World Series loss, is buried with a jersey.
Thank you.
Thanks, Steve.
Little Lene, Fezzy. Hi, Lene.
Hi, Lene.
Hi, Will. Hi, Fez.
Hi, honey.
What are you doing, sweetheart?
Okay, the bit is over.
That's it, huh?
Yeah.
Out of the mouth of babes, Fezzy.
No more.
No more.
No more.
No All more.
Right. No ma.
Okay. Thank you, honey.
Thank you.
Yeah, bye-bye, Lene.
All right, bye-bye. There she goes. What a good girl.
You hit my spot. Oh, yeah?
Did she say that?
I'm not sure.
You hit my spot. Oh, yeah?
We'll take one more.
That might have been her.
We'll take one more break. We'll be right back.
One more.
It's Ron and Fez and Moore on WNEW.
Ron and Fez. 1027 WNEW. In the world of light and sounds, beepers and bumpers, young and old will compete for the grand title. All will be in competition for the grand exalted title of the Pinball Wizard. Tomorrow night, the best of the best will be brought together for the Fireball Pinball Machine Tournament. And let the games begin.
From ClassicPinball.com, the Fireball Pinball Machine will be awarded tomorrow night at Ron and Fez.
Not a night to miss, Fezzy. If you're ever a pinball fan in your life, find out who is the best in New York City tomorrow night.
The tournament will begin tomorrow night on the show. Kevin from ClassicPinball.com, he'll be officiating the whole thing.
It should be very exciting. It should be very exciting.
$2,500 Fireball Pinball Machine on the line.
Unfortunately for me, Fezzy, I can't play because I'd win this thing going away. I'd win going away.
You hit my spot.
Yes.
Oh, yeah?
That means I get a free ball. Here is John. John, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, John.
Hey, guys. Was that the sweet Melissa Moan?
John?
You hit my spot. Oh, yeah?
There's the winning cowbell, John.
Very good.
All right, John, you hold on the line. You're going to the big-ass prize closet, getting a Game Boy Advance system. That's courtesy of Nintendo. You can check them out online at GameBoyAdvance.com. Congratulations.
That's you know what's strange, Fezzy? Tomorrow night, the last Sweet Melissa Moan of the night that we'll be doing.
That is it. So tomorrow night, if you're going to hear it, listen for that Sweet Melissa Moan.
Yeah.
It's your last night to do it.
Right.
That's sad.
Other than that, we might be going for the chicken parmesan eating championship. Every time you hear somebody eating a chicken parm, a free chicken parm,
please call in. 877-692-1027. Now, we said congratulations to Jim. Congratulations, Ronnie, to a man in Pennsylvania, Peter Nowak, I think is how you say his name. Yeah. He's been named Cheapskate of the Year, Ronnie.
Way to go, big man.
This is the first annual Cheapskate of the Year competition done by the Philadelphia Inquirer, their Cheapskate contest. He won because, Ronnie, he cleans and reuses his dental floss.
Oh.
Is that disgusting?
Now, dental floss, not very expensive.
No. He says this actually saves him $5.06 a year.
I cannot stand cheap people.
Oh.
Now, sometimes when you have older people, and I guess most of them are even gone now, that lived through the Depression, they have a problem of just being comfortable because they went through times where they were really starving. I had a great-grandmother who used to get up in the morning and make a cup of tea and then use that tea bag all day into the late hours.
Oh, my gosh. My grandparents constantly reusing tea bags.
And we'd go, look, there's all these other tea bags. And she just, oh, no, I could never. And we're going to have an effing tea bag. But, you know.
My grandfather may have been the cheapest person I ever knew.
Yeah.
He, no lie, would not let my grandmother use the electric stove.
Really?
The electricity costs money. He had built a shed out in his backyard.
Yeah.
And had an old wood-burning stove. No lie. That every day they had, like cave people.
Right.
Had to get up and start the fire. And he had like a smokestack coming out of this little shed.
All right, so it wasn't even in the regular house?
No, it was out in like a little shanty thing out in the backyard.
Yeah. So he would make her cook out there?
Yeah, they cooked out there every night.
What year was this?
Let's see, he passed in 82.
So, in the 70s.
Yes.
They had a wood-burning stove that they would actually fry on, not just like barbecue.
Right,
but it
would
be like the kind that you would see in the old movies.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Where, like, you had the little grill on the front that opened up, like a door, and you put the fire in there, and then it actually had burner areas.
I had an aunt with a coal stove that would never upgrade it. But she was like a great-great aunt. She was this little old lady. And also, they had rebuilt the whole area except for her one little shanty house. You know what I mean? Like, there's apartments and highways zipping by. I don't know whether some people, you know, like I said, if you've ever starved in your life, that's a panicky type of thing, and, you know, it's almost like a phobia. But some people, there's no reason for them to be that cheap.
Yeah. I mean, you could, forget having a meal there.
Yeah.
If you were a kid in his house and you didn't finish your food, oh my gosh, the horror stories.
Right.
We don't know if we'll have food tomorrow.
Yeah, sure.
And you'd look and you go, you got cupboards full of food.
Take it out on the wood burning stove. It's no problem at all. Hey, Eric, you're on the Fez.
Hey, Eric.
Hey, how you doing, Ron? How Fez? How's it going?
Yeah.
It's Eric from Elmwood Park, New Jersey, and I have the cheapest mother you could ever imagine. She would save every single tin or every plastic item from every fast food place you could imagine.
All right, so she would, like, save, like, the little box that the food came in?
Yeah, like the little metal tins from the pizzeria, or if you got, like, another fast food place, the little plastic things with the tops.
Yeah.
And she would wash them and save them. It was ridiculous.
Man, I know Graham.
What would you do with them later?
I know.
Save them and heat stuff up in them. It was ridiculous.
So she did use them. She wasn't.
Yeah, she would use them over again.
But how are you
going
to really reuse that little tin from a pizza thing?
It was absolutely insane.
Yeah. All right, thanks. See it. Here's Nick. Nick, you're on Ron and Fez. How are you?
Hey, Nick.
Hey, guys. Cardholder 6542. I had a friend whose parents were so cheap. One time I went to get a glass of milk out of the fridge, and it had cereal in it left over from the day before.
Ew.
Oh, God.
Is that disgusting?
So they poured it back in the carton?
Saving the cereal
back in the
milk.
Carton.
Is that gross or what?
That's actually sick and twisted. And like, it's going to actually, you know, between that and the backwash, you could end up sick.
Right, yeah.
Costing you a lot more money.
You've got milk that has sat out for at least some time.
Yeah.
Plus a kid slurping in it and pouring right in back in the carton. You're so gross, people.
Anthony, you're on Manifest.
Hey, Anthony. Up, guys?
Yeah.
Two things. My mom was so cheap, I had to bring big brown, like, shopping bag, grocery bags for lunch. And
that would always happen to me at every once in a while. It would, like, be, like, at the end of the month or something where my mom would stick one little sandwich in a big, giant, stupid shopping bag.
And this is the ultimate nightmare.
Yeah.
I rarely went to the barber because my mother would cut my hair for me.
You know, and you know what? Mm. There's still a lot of people who do that and think they're saving money, and you look like crap.
Yeah.
And there's some people I know, I'm thinking to myself, and you know who I'm talking about.
I know exactly who you're talking about.
Joseph P., and let's leave it at that.
Right.
That can't be getting a professional haircut.
Claims they do.
Yeah.
And then always bitches about it. You know that's a mom cut.
Right. That's a mom cut if you ever saw one. And, you know, there's always some old Italian barber who hasn't raised his prices. You don't need to go to some stylish place, but you still need a professional haircut.
Man, my dad, he got one of these things. It wasn't the Flowbee, but he got something off of TV.
Yeah.
And he was going to cut
off. Like a comb or something?
Yeah, with a blade in it. A comb with a blade.
I remember when that was big.
And he was cutting me and my brother's hair.
Yeah.
And was going to save all. And he was just butchering us. And the crew cuts were out by then.
Yeah, no kid.
And that was the only way to get
it fixed. The other thing was just like it was just scraping your hair with a razor, like a dry razor. So it was basically ripping your hair out.
Yeah, you weren't cutting it. You were thinning it.
Now, I'm all for trying every Ronco product once, but I've never been happy with any of them. Hey, Christy, you're on the Fez.
Hey, Christy.
Hi, happy birthday, Fezzy.
Well, thank you.
Sunday is his birthday.
Sunday's my birthday.
He has risen, is what we say on Fez's birthday.
Thank you.
I'm the one who bull rushed you.
Oh, God.
Oh, jeez.
Oh.
Hey, anyway. Are you coming in for Fezzy's birthday?
Oh, God. Ronnie, we don't have that much cake.
Yes.
Fezzy, why do you got to be that way? Christy
don't
seems like it. Christy, what can we do for you? We're in the middle of a show, honey.
What? Oh, I was calling because I had a great aunt who would, once you open the present, she would save that wrapping paper.
You know, a lot of people do that. They'll save the wrapping paper and try. And, you know, what happens is you just clutter your house up.
Yeah.
You're not going to reuse that wrapping paper.
I save gift bags, but never the paper.
What do you do with a gift bag?
I re-gift in them.
Oh, that's sick and twisted. So that's when I get something, I go, oh, Fez went to a nice store. No, you just have the gift bag, and then you stick an old 8-track tape in there that you got from Black Girl. Here, Ron, I got this from Tiffany's. Cheap bastard.
I especially save anything from a good store.
Andrew, you're on Manifest.
Hey, Andrew.
Boys. Yeah. Hey, I had this friend, he's so cheap. If you invited him over for dinner, all he'd bring is a Carvel cake.
I know a guy like that.
A Carvel cake is a very nice dessert, mister.
Hey, John.
Maybe some people are just frugal, not cheap.
John, you're on Manifest.
Hey, boys.
Hi, John.
Yeah. My father-in-law is a WW2 vet.
Yeah.
Ever since the war, he takes a shower in the sink in the bathroom with as much water as it takes to fill up a helmet.
All right, I know a lot of those guys. I was at a guy before who tried to tell me when we were at his house, oh, the water pressure's low and everything. Well, you turn on the spigot, get wet. Well, this is like at his cottage, right?
Uh-huh.
Then soap up. You turn it off, soap up. And I'm like, I'm not going to sit here soaped up with no water running like an animal.
God, that's gross. I would feel dirtier after that shower.
That's how I felt. I said to my chick, I go,
soap scum.
I go, we're going to stay here tonight, and we're going to have dinner, but guess what? We're not sleeping over, so I have to go through this for a couple days. This vacation ends now.
The shower ordeal. Oh, my father went through a water-saving kick one time, and his thing was, when we took our showers, as soon as we were done, he would come in and check, and we shouldn't be in there any long enough to steam up the mirror.
You know,
he would check the mirror for steam.
Your dad realizes that's prime batching time when you're at a certain age, where you can just sit in that shower and relax. Hey, Mike, you're on Run a Fest.
Hey, Mike.
Mike.
Mike, go ahead, buddy.
Yeah, what's up, Ron? What's up, Fez?
Yeah.
Virtual big ass card number 1234.
That's what you want is the number, buddy.
That's
go
it.
Ahead.
Yeah, do you ever stick water in the shampoo bottle to stretch it out a little longer?
Well, I've done that.
I've done that in an emergency situation. I wouldn't do it when I was, you know what I mean? If I went, oh, F, we got no shampoo. I'd stick a little water in there and get it out. But I would not want to think like, oh, here's the best way to handle this.
Yeah, it doesn't work too good on conditioner either.
Yeah, it's awful.
Yeah.
All right, my grandma used to get like a gallon of orange juice, right?
Yeah.
And she would split it up into two different jars, into two half gallons, fill the rest of it up with water.
Oh, jeez.
And then dump in like a cup or two of sugar and make what she called her orange aid. And get 2 gallons of crap juice out of 1 decent gallon of orange juice.
Oh, my God.
And we always had this watered-down orange drink that she made. Oh, you got it served at every meal.
Yeah. Hey, Rob, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Rob.
What's going on, Ronnie?
Yeah.
Fez, what's up?
Hey,
I talked
buddy.
To you earlier today online, Ron. My dad is one of these crazy guys. He's about 65 years old. Just missed the depression.
Yeah.
But he won't turn on, like, the air conditioning for fear it might break and he might have to pay for a new air conditioner.
Well, a lot of guys, they try to fight off that air conditioning thing. And let me tell you, the reason why you have air conditioning is to use it.
That's why it's in the house.
Right. You start to break a sweat, you turn on the air conditioner.
My father would refuse to turn on the air conditioning. We were in Florida, for God's sake. We never got the air conditioning on.
My parents won't use air conditioning to this day. And I go down their place in the summer, and it's 100 effing degrees. It's in Maryland near the Chesapeake Bay. It is so hot you could die. I walked out and just put a hose over my head. And I said, I can't keep my children here. I go, you're killing me. We started to go, I just sat in my car with the air conditioning on and smoked. And they're going, it's not so bad. I go, it's awful. And you two are going to die like old people.
Just some relief. That's all you need. When I first started making any sort of money in radio, my father refused to turn the air conditioning on. Ronnie, know this is a true story. I took a $50 bill out of my wallet, crumbled it up, threw it in his fat face, and said, here, how about some air conditioning now? I'll pay for it.
What did he say?
We turned it on. He took my 50. He's no fool.
Yeah, you bounce it off his chest. It's like throwing it at a Yogi Bear. He's going to come down with it.
Throwing a fish towards a grizzly.
Hey, Joyce, you're around the fence.
Hey, Joyce.
Hi, everybody. How you guys doing?
Hi, Joyce.
Hello,
hi.
Joyce.
Hi, Joyce.
I have an aunt. We went to a barbecue. She's the cheapest thing walking. Same woman who puts one slice of meat in between two pieces of bread and calls it a sandwich. We had a big barbecue. Family was there. 25 people. We're all starving. Ron, with grilled onions, everything. We're waiting for these hamburgers. She was supposed to bring them.
Right.
And we're waiting. She comes with a small tray. So we're all looking. You know, she puts them on the grill, and we're tasting them. And she filled the hamburger meat to stretch it with filler. But she didn't want to buy the hamburger meat.
What kind of filler?
The hamburger helper?
It tasted like...
breadcrumbs?
Like fat. Like lard, like
oh,
something.
God.
Oh, we were all starving. 90 degrees. We're all by the pool. We just can't wait to eat. And we take one bite. Oh, my God. I will never forget that for the rest of my life. And that 1 ounce of seasoning.
I can't live like that.
That's
I can't
horrible.
Eat
horrible.
Horrible. I still have nightmares about that. Now I'm like a fiend. I go to the restaurant and pick up meat from them just to avoid that bad taste again.
When you go to someone's house and you feel like you have to stop and eat first.
That's bad.
Before you get to their house for dinner. Because you know.
Yeah, you will.
Yeah.
Same woman who hangs bounty towels on a clothesline because she doesn't want to throw them away.
Man.
I'm not kidding.
No way.
She washes out straws. I've never met anybody like that.
She washes out straws.
And hangs them on the line with a clothespin. Clothespin.
Be careful. She's going to be taking a toothbrush to her toilet tissue. Trying to use that again.
You.
All right. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Joyce.
Here's one from GVAC that I really like on the instant feedback, Fuzzy. He says that his Sicilian grandfather, who lived through the Depression, so believe me when I tell you, that's a whole different can of worms. I mean, for me, I have no idea what it's like to go through hard times. I mean, I've been broke.
Yeah.
But never starving, never, you know, oh, how do we eat?
Nobody knows how those people think.
So, but he says that his Sicilian grandfather actually keeps a daily ledger of every penny he spends during the day. So it's one of those where you're licking a pencil. I'm going to lick this. There you go. I gave $2 to GVAC for milk. I got back 38 cents. Let me get that in the asset column.
Move that into the black ink.
Here's
that's cheap.
Hey, Brad. Brad, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey, Brad.
What's up, Ronnie?
Yeah.
Yo, listen, when I used to go out to dinner with my grandfather, I have four sisters, and he's one of 13. So, you know, money was tight when he was growing up. Now when we used to go out to these buffets, he would always, you know, we would eat, and then he would always make us fill up our plates and then ask for a doggy bag before we're ready to leave.
Oh, jeez.
How embarrassing to drag everybody into
now,
it.
Now, I had an aunt who always would leave every family situation with two plates to take home plates. So she can have it tomorrow. And everybody's like, yeah, great. What about us? Don't you think we eat tomorrow? And yet here you are.
We'd love to have a nice turkey sandwich tomorrow.
Right. It's not your home. And yet you feel like, yeah, and I don't have an extra meal tomorrow. We invite you to dinner. Not to lunch tomorrow and then dinner tomorrow night as well. You're filling up here.
She's won 2 days of meals at your home.
Right. And she did it every time, and my mom would just coddle her.
Sure, yeah.
Coddle her. And it's not like she was ever nice to the kids.
My uncle, one time, my mother was there at his house. He split a can of Campbell's soup for lunch three ways between three people. Just kept watering it down.
What the F? You know, your dad could go out and get a burger. Why force him through this meal? Your dad's not a broke man. Instead, he has to sit down and act like a hobo because the other guy is cheap.
And as they enjoy stone soup.
Right. Here, I'll just have some of your pepper. Son of a bitch.
877-692-1027.
Donna, you're on Manifest.
Hey, Donna.
Hi, guys. How you doing?
Good. Talking about cheapskates.
Oh, my God. Listen to this. When my brother and I were kids, we would go out with my mom and dad to eat. We would always have to go to, like, the Olive Garden or Red Lobster because my dad would tell them it was our birthday for the free cake, and they would come sing to us.
Oh, jeez.
We would
and you
go
know
and do this so many times that one time the manager came up and asked for ID.
Oh!
I wanted to die. Like, we ate there all the time. These people knew. And, you know, that dumb song they sing?
Yeah.
You know, whatever.
Right.
Just
right
for that little, horrible, hard piece of little free cake.
It's one thing to be cheap, but to drag other people into your
right
cheapness is wrong.
It's just sick and twisted and wrong. Okay, bye, guys.
Bye, Donna. Thank you for the call.
G-Vac's grandfather's writing this all in his ledger now.
He's got to keep track of this.
Carry the two. I gave the paper boy $1.35. Like he's, like it's 1840, Fez, where you have a big ledger.
He's Ebenezer Scrooge. He's
right
got Bob Cratchit doing the numbers for him.
He's got the Bob Cratchit angle working.
Going nuts because at night he's 8 cents off his balance. He doesn't know what's going on.
Here is, Eric. Eric, you're on Fez.
Hi, Eric.
Buddies, what's up?
Hey,
what?
Buddy.
Hey, my father used to put buckets in the shower. So anytime my mother or me or him would use the shower, the water would collect in the buckets, you know, that fell off our bodies
right,
and didn't
right
hit us. And he'd use that water to water the plants in the house.
So in the meantime, you're trying to take a shower, but you got an old rusty bucket between your legs.
I got buckets. I'm trying to avoid buckets throughout my whole shower experience growing up. It was a disaster.
That is terrible.
Eric, Grandpa used to keep drums and tubs out in the yard. He would catch the rainwater. That's what they used in the washing machine.
Jesus. And you know, another thing, you know, I grew up on Long Island. I didn't have cable growing up.
Right.
And I'm not sure, but I think that's a form of child abuse.
Yeah, it really could be.
Sure.
You know, when everybody else is seeing the show and you're not part of it. You're the only kid going to school. You don't know who Cartman is. That's wrong. All right, here's another situation, Fez.
All right.
I know this family. They told me that their dad, because he was a cheap bastard, and there was like eight of them, they were Irish, right?
Sure.
Used to make the kids all had to get a bath, like after 7 o'clock, it's bath time. They'd fill up the tub once.
Oh! Oh!
Then kid after kid would go hopping in there as the night went on. Now here's the deal.
Oldest to youngest?
Yeah. Well, whoever was smart enough to get there first. Yes. In that family, you're busting your ass to get to the bath.
Number 8 is just sitting on top of the water.
No, yeah, right.
It's so thick. Oh. God, that's awful.
Yeah, I know. I suppose you're going in after your sisters with their big clumps of hair hanging down there.
Oh, gross.
You're getting in a fresh bathtub, and you got sister long hair all over the place.
You might as well just go bathe in a crick.
You might as well bang your own family. All right, here's the other deal. They knew they weren't that poor. They knew to themselves, we could have separate baths. And that made them hate that man.
Yeah. You grow up resenting the cheapness.
You know, the best way to go through life is like Jackie Gleason. You spend it as soon as you make it.
Oh, man, you pick up the check. Drinks are on you.
Right. You're buying drinks for the house. How's everybody doing?
And what are you? You're beloved.
Yeah, you are.
You're beloved.
Yeah.
Not resented.
Of course, when the money's gone, you won't have any friends, but who gives an F?
You had a nice run.
Hey, everybody. Jackie's here. How are you?
Toot. Let everybody up. Toot sure.
The money's here. We drink tonight. Hey, Chris. Chris, you're on I Run a Fez.
Hey, Chris.
And then remember, he played that really cheap guy, too, Jackie Gleason. Chris.
Chris, go ahead, buddy.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got my grandmother, God bless her. She used to wash the paper plates.
Oh, jeez. It's the whole
And thing. Not even the wax-coated ones. I'm talking about the regular paper plates.
Like the
plates.
White ones.
And put them back on the dish rack and let them dry.
It's terrible. It's a terrible way. It's, you know, with some people, it's a disease. There are millionaires that hide toilet paper and stuff.
Yeah, I guess they think they're going to lose their fortune. My mother, she gets these new, I think they're from Glad. They're like these plastic containers. It's cheap Tupperware. It's disposable Tupperware is
right.
What it is. She keeps them. I mean, it says dishwasher safe on the box.
Sure.
She will run the mileage up on those things as much as she can.
Hey, Doug, you're on Manifest.
Hey, Doug.
Hey, my father, I saw him, I come into the bathroom one time, and he's spitting the mouthwash back into the bottle.
Oh, my God.
Oh, that's bad.
And my mother, she takes the toilet paper, and she unravels, you know, it's 2-ply?
Yeah.
She unravels the top ply onto another roll.
The time you spend doing these things. You could be out earning money to buy another roll.
God, I'm disgusted. All right, we got to take a break here, Fuzzy.
Oh, that mouthwash thing's grossing me out.
I know.
And the 8-kid tub water. I'm all gnarled.
And then when it was done, Fez, they had to drink it. I made that part up. I just wanted to freak you a little bit.
I'm freaking. I feel like I need a bath.
Itching. You want to take a bath after Rory and Hawk are done?
No. Please, no.
Who knows who spunked in that tub? By the way, Heckler tells me G-Vac gets his haircuts at barber school. 877-692-1027. You're listening to Ron and Fez.
Ron and Fez, 1027 WNEW.
We're Ron and Fez. Ron Bennington, Fez Whatley with you, 1027 WNEW.
Fez, another one bites the dust. Elaine from Seinfeld's show got pulled until next year.
Oh, okay. So, again, the alumni curse continues there. These people can't pull off anything without Jerry.
Now, what was the, and you know if Jerry tried to make another show, it would blow as well.
Oh, right, yeah.
He's going to do the smart thing and not even try it.
That way he looks like the genius.
All right, Jason Alexander's sitcom got canceled quick.
Bob Patterson.
Kramer's got pulled quick.
The Michael Richards Show.
And now Elaine's, they are just taking back for some retooling.
Oh, God. That's the kiss of death. Her show, Watching Ellie. I call it Watching Smelly. That show's bad.
That's witty.
Thank you.
That whole Watching Smelly thing? Oh, that's a scream.
Maybe that's part of the retooling process.
Yeah.
They come back with Watching Smelly.
Here's how I'd retool it. Remove her from her husband, at least in a creative capacity, but for me personally, also in the marriage. The show blows.
It's awful. Why does it have to be so gimmicky? You know, where they're doing it in real time or whatever.
Now, let me ask you this.
In one camera.
How quick did they decide it was a curse? After Jason Alexander?
I think they started talking about it as soon as Michael Richards bombed out. Because Bob Patterson was coming up,
yeah,
and they were already saying, you know, is he going to strike out like Kramer did?
But why would that be a curse because one person did it? It'd be like if someone in your family died of a car crash. Oh, they're cursed. They are cursed.
They do call it the curse. So next week is going to be the last two installments of Watching Ellie with Julia Louis-Dreyfus.
Which would only be, what, the third or fourth one?
It's actually, they're going to have two next week, so it's going to be 6 and 7.
Hey, Scott. Scott, you're on Ron FS.
Hey, Scott.
How you guys doing?
Hey, buddy.
What about Larry David's TV show, Curb Your Enthusiasm?
I actually like that a lot. I think it's very funny.
Yeah, so do I. It's
but,
still on.
You know, that's only aimed at like 800,000 people a week or something. I mean, if you want to make it on network TV, you need like 15, 20 million watchers.
Still rules.
Yeah.
What about Putty's show, The Tick? Is The Tick still
gone.
On? Gone.
Putty's show's gone.
All right. Sorry, Putty.
No one brings up the fact that Newman had a little spinoff deal.
What did Newman do?
He also, the whole time Seinfeld was on, he was playing that third planet from the sun.
Oh, third rock from the sun.
Whatever the hell it was.
Oh, yeah, he's playing
awful.
The cop.
It was awful. Hey, Steve. Steve, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, Steve.
Hey, guys. What's going on?
Yeah.
You know, this is the same thing as, like, what happens when you have a band and they all decide to do solo albums and all the solo albums suck.
Yeah, but sometimes, you know, somebody breaks out.
Yeah, I mean, actually, you know, The Who... The solo stuff, Daltrey's solo stuff was okay.
Yeah.
Townsend's was pretty good. But you look at, like, Kiss. All four of them did albums,
yeah,
and, like, one of them was barely listenable.
You know, I look at Kiss altogether, and I feel like they're cursed. what are some of the big curses out there?
All right, I guess you would have to say the Kennedy family.
The Kennedy family, here's the weird thing. How can they be cursed when they do so well right up until they die?
How can one family be so blessed and so cursed?
Yeah. Yeah, they're both. But, yeah, there does seem, especially after the last one, more than ever before, with John John, it feels like there is a dark cloud over that family, even though they live large when things are going well.
Well, it seems like as soon as they start getting excited about something again, someone has to come, God, has to come and pull the carpet out from under them.
Well, actually kill them.
Yes.
Who's
I mean,
ever
the
doing
whole
it?
Family.
Yeah, oh. Yeah, but I mean, who's ever doing the best gets killed.
Or they nip it.
Or accidentally kills or rapes someone else. So it's very weird when that happens, right? The Kennedys, definitely.
Yeah, you got, obviously, Joe, the Forgotten Kennedy, Robert, President Kennedy.
Young Joe, the Forgotten Kennedy.
Yes.
That is my favorite. The President.
Teddy's Chappaquiddick.
Bobby, of course.
Right. David Kennedy with the drug overdose.
Oh, yeah, he's the one that died down in Florida, right?
Right.
Like Palm Beach or something.
And didn't one just recently die skiing, like Sonny
Bono? I
think
that was Michael.
Michael Kennedy.
Who was reckless, they said.
Right.
He was reckless.
And, of course, JFK Jr.
Yeah. Who literally could have taken it all the way?
Yeah.
I mean, that kid was heading towards the end zone.
And people wanted it. They were getting out of his way to head towards the end zone.
Rob, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Rob.
What's up, Ron and Fez? 2640 checking in. What about the Red Sox curse?
You know, you cannot say, after what happened against them with the Mets, that's not an absolute curse. That has to be a curse. There's no other way to explain that other than something otherworldly.
There's forces working against them.
Forces. Supernatural forces are working against them.
I read this somewhere. I don't remember where I saw it. But they were looking for, I guess, when the Babe left the Red Sox.
Yeah.
He got upset and threw his piano into a pond or a lake, and they think that's what started the curse. Now they're looking to drain this lake or pond or search it to find this piano and hopefully exorcise the demons from this piano that got thrown in a pond.
They're freaking panicking up there.
I mean,
they're
exactly.
Panicking. And guess what? It ain't going to happen this year either, Red Sox fans. Here's Jeff. Jeff, you're on Ron FS.
Hey, Jeff.
Okay. Hey, guys.
Yeah.
Big ass 138. Check out that little number. Huh?
Hoo-ah! Way to right. go. Way to get
Beauty.
There.
The Superman curse. George Reeves.
All right, George Reeves. All right, let's slow down. George Reeves was the TV Superman, right?
Right.
And he supposedly was either thrown out of a building or thought he could fly and jumped out of a building.
Right.
He died. Chris Reeve, awful.
Right.
Right. And I think there's another, the third Superman who bought it, but... Check us out. Jerry was a big Superman fan. And I think the Superman curse is carrying over.
That's interesting. Remember, Jerry always had Superman stuff up. All right, then also you look at Margot Kidder and Richard Pryor.
All from Superman 3.
Yeah. All right, now movie curses. Probably the most famous is the Poltergeist curse.
Oh, yeah. Dropping like flies there.
That's when little Heather O'Rourke died from an infection. And this is a little girl. You would never expect this.
And I think totally curable. I mean, no problem if she had gotten medical attention. I think her family, it was a situation we don't believe in doctors because of our religion.
Yeah, that's why I always head straight out to the doctor. All right, then the little Dunn girl in there.
Dominic Dunn.
Yeah, who was Dominic Dunn's daughter.
Dominique.
Yeah, she was Dominique.
All right.
Was strangled by a boyfriend.
Let's see.
And then you had a couple other people. The guy who played the death in there, he died.
Oh, Kane.
Yeah.
Kane is dead from Poltergeist.
Yeah. No, apparently, I guess you could take, you know, some of that stuff, it seems like the older people, yeah, you can understand. Whatever happened to the little boy in Poltergeist? You never saw him again.
No, I don't know. Maybe that tree did eat him.
Yeah.
I'm not sure. And, of course, Craig T. Nelson went on to work with Jerry Van Dyke.
Ah. It's awful.
Rough.
Hey, Mike, you're on the Fez.
Hey, guys, what's going on?
Yeah.
Hey, Mike.
What about the curse of the morning show on WNEW? Start back with that retarded chick and the other guy.
Yeah, it's been pretty cursed. And then you look at all the different sports guys.
The Menudo.
Yeah, the Menudo. But now, Fezzy, now it seems like something's bubbling there. Something's happening.
Well, now you got Pharrell.
Yeah.
Pharrell's the man.
Yeah, who's cursed before he even came to WNEW?
Yeah.
That's kind of self-inflicted cursing.
But now he's Pharrell and Fez, so it should work out for him.
He's beautiful.
They're beautiful. Hey, Green Lantern, you're on Run of Fez.
Green Lantern?
Hey, what's up, guys? Big X 1869. Thank you.
Go ahead, Al Jordan.
Oh, thanks. I got how about the Saturday Night Live curse?
What's that?
You know, John Belushi died of a drug overdose, and then Gilman Radner, then Chris Farley, and then
yeah, they've had quite a few people die on there, but the show's been on for 25 years.
When you have 25 years of a cast of what? Usually no less than 12 people.
It's probably more of a curse of how many of their sketches that go on to make bad movies.
The ladies' man curse.
Oh, yeah, that's one.
All right, thank you very much.
Happy birthday, Fez.
Well, thank you. Thank you, Green Lantern. Right, you got Green Lantern for my birthday.
Well, you know, I try to make you happy. And that was the Black Green Lantern.
Oh.
I forget his name.
What is it, John Smith? No, that's Steel.
I never know.
I can't remember now.
Let's go, John. John, you're on
Stewart. Stewart, that's who it is. Hey, John.
How you doing, Ron? Hi, Fez.
Hey, buddy.
The James Dean car curse.
What's the dealio with that?
James Dean crashed in it.
He crashed in it, and I think it was, like, brought to a museum, and then it was stolen, someone else crashed in it.
Really?
They said they rebuilt it, and everywhere it went, and like something went wrong with the car.
Was this car Christine?
There it goes again.
I had never heard that one about the James Dean car crash. Hey, Fonzo. Fonzo, you're on the Run of Fez. How you doing there, Fonzo?
Hi, Fonzo.
You remember the Von Erich family?
Oh, God.
All right, let's go over the Von Erich family. Right. We're kind of like
the Kennedys. When they were kids, there was a young son who died first, got electrocuted.
Yeah, he had Jack.
And they went in,
Hold on, Fonzo. Let Fezzy handle
it. Yeah, Jackie got electrocuted when he was a kid.
Right.
Then when they started wrestling, David died in Japan.
Right.
Then you had Mike, who got the toxic shock syndrome.
Right.
Now, how can a man get toxic shock syndrome? You got to be a woman to get that.
I think it's code for drug overdose.
Well, what happened with Mike was when he was wrestling, he had loose bowels, if I can say that nicely.
Yeah, you can.
And he would shove stuff.
Oh.
So to make sure he didn't crap himself during a wrestling match. So, and he got sick from that.
Was he using tamponies?
I guess so. So I guess he was actually using tamponies or at least a dirty rag. I don't know. And he got toxic shock syndrome. Oh, got a fever of, like, I think 108, something crazy. Came back from that. Didn't die from it. Came back from it.
Nice.
Tried to wrestle. Couldn't make it. Couldn't put on the weight. Killed himself.
Oh, okay. Why just not say killed himself? Why do we got to hear he had a dirty rag stuffed?
Then the baby of the family, Chris Von Erich, never grew to be bigger than 5 foot. Couldn't make it in the wrestling business. Killed himself.
Yeah.
Kerry Von Erich at his motorcycle accident, had the fake leg, got depressed, killed himself.
So a lot of those people killed themselves in that family.
Right, and now Fritz is gone, too, and I don't know if Fritz killed himself or not.
I'd like to think that he did.
Yeah, just to keep
I'd even like to think
line.
That the little kid that got electrified did it on purpose. Electrocuted.
So, and I guess now that's just Kevin Von Erich left. You have that big of a family, and you're all alone in the world now.
Right, you're having Thanksgiving dinner for one.
Mm-hmm, getting a defrosting a Swanson's. That ain't right. That's a curse.
All right, here's the Saturday Night Live people that are dead. Fezzy, see if this comes across as a curse to you. John Belushi, dead.
Right.
Andy Kaufman appeared all the time, including the first show, dead. Gilda Radner, dead. Chris Farley, dead. Michael O'Donoghue, Mr. Mike, dead.
Oh, yeah.
Phil Hartman, dead.
Right.
Dentrina Vance, I don't remember her, dead. Garrett Morris, shot, still alive.
Oh, okay.
Julia Sweeney, cancer, still alive. You know, I don't count the any of that stuff still alive, but...
No, I think if that's just par for the course. You're going to have a show that's big, that many cast members over 25 years.
Yeah.
You're going to lose some.
I think it's more of a curse, what happens after the news, that the show's never funny. That's the curse. Whatever happens after Weekend Update.
If that was a half-hour show, it would kick. 877-692-1027.
Eddie, you're on Iron Fez.
Hey, Eddie.
Hey, guys. What about the Sports Illustrated cover curse?
That one, they've actually done a Sports Illustrated on, and you read it, and it seems like it's a curse.
Who got the cover of that curse issue?
I think it was Death. But it's amazing. I think it's still out there. It's a collectible. How many people... Okay, Black Cat went on the cover of that. Thank you very much. But... you start to look at this stuff, and it seems like if you get that cover of the magazine, you're going to blow out a knee, you're going to blow the big game, you're going to lose the next big prize fight. It's just happened time and time and time again.
And it doesn't matter how heavily favored you or your team are, you will blow it.
Right.
That's a great curse.
Yeah, that's a cold curse. And it's one that you can actually have fun playing along with. As you say, oh, look, Bo Jackson's on the cover.
Bye-bye, hips.
Here's James. James, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, James.
4233.
All right, buddy.
Welcome
to Ron and Fez.
What about the Different Strokes curse?
The Different Strokes curse. Well, you got the one dead girl.
Yeah. And Todd Bridges.
Oh, and then the legal trouble that the other two got into.
Yeah, that's not...
It's not so cursy. They're just bad kids.
Right. Here's one, Fezzy, that I would love to look into. This comes to us from Jacob on Ron and Fez.
I got married, Jacob.
What about the quarterback retarded kid curse? That is unbelievable.
That's
a very
wild.
Good one, Jacob.
That's excellent. Man, quarterback has a kid, and there is something wrong with that kid.
Most of the time, it's some kind of brain disease. Or, the body's not working correctly, or they have just awful things that happen. These quarterback kids.
All right, you got...
And any big quarterback you mentioned, it seemed like they got a retarded kid.
Yeah. All right, Jim Kelly's got...
problems.
Right? He's got problems. I don't even know what that is. Yeah. Doug Flutie's got the autistic kid.
Flutie Flake.
Right. Dan Marino's got a Flutie Flake of his own. He's got an autistic kid. Boomer Esiason, cystic fibrosis. We got a thump gunner.
Yeah,
is what they used to say.
It's amazing. It goes so deep that I don't even know if there's a starting quarterback who doesn't have something wrong with his kid.
We saw what happened to Phil Simms' kid in the Texas Oklahoma game. Just retarded.
Just go on and on and on with it. It's awful.
It's like the dads have been gifted with so many talents and good genes, like they have nothing but crap genes to pass on to their offspring.
Yeah, but why don't, like, defensive linemen have retarded kids? What is it about the quarterback position that you're going to have a problem with your kid? And normally it's a son. Do you notice that?
Yeah.
And you think, man, who would want a son more than a quarterback to go, hey, I'll teach you this and that? Because most of those guys also played b-ball. They were pitchers. You know, so you're thinking to yourself, well, here's a guy who would really enjoy raising a young boy. And then they have these physical problems that they never even get a chance in life.
Yeah, it's a total curse because it's not like the parents are doing something or the kids got into trouble. It's they're born with this. These birth defects.
All right, here is a strange situation, Fezzy. Here is a script called A Took. Have you ever heard of this?
No, what is A Took?
A Took was supposed to be a movie, one of those, almost like a Crocodile Dundee, fish out of water situations, where the lead character would be an Eskimo who comes to America and all kinds of funny hijinks start.
All right, clever.
They had given this to John Belushi, who was looking it over when he died. Later, Sam Kinison was actually green-lighted. Our friend Mitchell Walters was doing the rewrites on it. Sam, of course, passes away.
Right? Sam gets killed.
Then it moves on to John Candy. We
oh
know what
gosh.
Happens there. Finally, the last person looking at it, Chris Farley.
Oh, man.
So, whatever reason, they wanted a nice fat comedian to play the big crazy Eskimo and, you know, he's at a sushi restaurant and he's just shoveling raw fish in his mouth. And
funny.
That was supposed to be the joke. Four of these guys all die while looking the script over.
That, oh, that gave me chills. That thing is haunted.
That's very bizarre.
Nobody look at that script.
Yeah.
Burn that script.
I don't even like thinking about it. I wouldn't even go to IMDb and look for it.
No, uh-uh. Catch something right through your computer.
Yeah. The James Dean Porsche has been mailed to us. The guy who actually bought the car when it was wrecked, the James Dean Porsche.
All right.
He, it fell on the mechanic's legs while they were fixing it.
Oh, God.
Popped off of it. Two drivers were using parts from the car after that in a race. One died when his car flipped over. The other hit a tree.
All right. Too weird. Too weird.
After the race, kid tries to steal the steering wheel, gashes his arm. Both tires stole from the wreck were both blown out, causing accidents on two different cars.
Okay, so people still using parts off this car.
Later, they give the car to the California Highway Patrol. The garage burns down that it's in, destroying every car except for the James Dean Porsche.
Oh, God.
When it's transported later, a teenager was in it. It doesn't even make sense. But it actually fell on somebody and killed them.
Oh.
So this is
another death.
This is the Christine.
You're absolutely right.
Car.
Oh, that is too weird. I bet the car somehow started that fire in the garage and did everything else.
I'm glad to know that you're not just leaping here, Fezzy, that you're sticking with scientific evidence.
Nobody go near this car.
And you know what? I had never... Wait a minute. What's that car behind you, Fez? It's...
Where'd those headlights come from? Get out of the way! Someone shove me out of the way!
Someone shove me out of the way. That's lazy. When you're literally... So lazy.
My legs! My legs!
Okay, that's a little bit. But I never heard that.
No, and no, here's the thing. If I had a chance, for some reason, someone wanted to give me something off the James Dean Porsche, and I knew this stuff, I would never accept it.
I'd still want it.
Really?
Yeah.
Cursed darer.
Yeah.
Cursed darer.
I'll put it on eBay. Here is...
And the site will fail.
Here is Ed. Ed, you're on the Run of Fest show. How you doing, Ed?
Hey, Ed.
How about the curse of Hill Street Blues? I mean, three people died on the show. One right,
wait,
show
oh, slow
was
it,
on.
Slow it down, big man. Who are the people so we can go over this? Because I've never heard this one.
All right. Remember the original chief? He died...
Right.
1983, while the show was still on.
The guy, he was the sarge out there.
Yeah, he was like the sarge, right? Yeah, you're right. He was great.
And then after the show, two other people died. Rene Enriquez, remember the bald Puerto Rican guy?
He. Oh yeah, he got AIDS and died.
Guy Keel Martin, he died.
Keel Martin is dead. Yeah. I didn't know that.
Yep.
Keelhold.
And everybody else on the show career died. When have you heard from Daniel J. Travanti?
Disappeared. I'm guessing
Veronica
back in the
Hamill,
bottle.
Where is she?
Back in the bottle.
all right, Dennis Franz, but
yeah,
that's
Dennis
one
Franz.
Out of...
Right.
Dennis Franz, who wasn't even the big guy on the show.
Yeah, he played two different characters.
Yeah. That's a weird one. All right, thanks, Ed.
I remember, Hey Now, Hank Kingsley used to be on that show in a dress.
Really? Hey Now.
He would always be in court in a dress.
Hey, Frank, you're on Run the Fez.
Hey, Frank.
How you guys doing?
Hey, buddy.
How about the curse of the best new artist Grammy?
How's that work?
Well, they win the Grammy, you never hear from them again.
All right, let's go over this. We'll try to get this up on the internet. So you're saying they win the best new artist in the Grammys.
Then they tank.
All right, let's go over this. Number 70 in 1970.
Okay.
Karen Carpenter. Well, that's a good career.
Yeah.
So that one doesn't work for you, Frank.
No.
71, Carly Simon.
Great career.
Yeah. Me too. 72, America. That's a big career.
Yeah.
73, Bette Midler. Huge career. 74, Marvin Hamlisch.
Who could be bigger?
Yeah. You couldn't
That's
ask more.
That's
kind of
thin.
All right. Well, Marvin Hamlisch, I mean, he's a Tony Award winner and also Oscar Award
right.
winner. That's big. Not that I'm a big fan myself, but it's gigantic.
Right.
Natalie Cole after that. She's still around. All right, 76, Starland Vocal Band. All right, there's one for you.
All right. Maybe that starts in 76.
I think that's when it kicks in.
All right, Debbie Boone. Debbie Boone in 77.
Oh, go bye-bye. All right.
78, Taste of Honey.
Oh, with that great song, Sukiyaki.
I don't even remember this. Find me Sukiyaki by Taste of Honey. 79, Ricky Lee Jones. She just played in New York not too long ago. Mm-hmm. 80, Chris Cross.
Oh, God.
81, Sheena Easton, still big in Vegas. 82, Men at Work.
Yep.
83, Culture Club. 84, Cyndi Lauper. 85, Sade. 86, Bruce Hornsby. 87, Jody Watley.
My cousin.
Then Tracy Chapman, Millie Vanilli, Mariah Carey. Oh, that shoots a hole in it.
Millie Vanilli actually had to give theirs back.
91, Mark Cohn. He was walking in Memphis, that son of a bitch. Number 2, Arrested Development. Then Tony Braxton. Sheryl Crow, Hootie, Leanne Rimes, Paula Cole, Lauryn Hill, Christina Aguilera, Shelby Lynn, and Alicia Keys. I don't know if it holds up. There's enough hits in there.
All right.
But there's definitely people who you never hear from again.
I'll bring back Joe Poo.
Who?
Joe Poo.
Joe Poo.
We'll bring back Paula Cole for
Joe Poo.
The dead one.
Poo.
Oh, you know who they mean?
Who?
Al Dukes.
Oh. I love Al Dukes.
Here's Pete. Pete, you're on Run the Fez.
Hey, Pete.
Hey, how's it going, guys?
Yeah.
Do me a favor, that I Took movie.
Yeah.
Okay. Send that script to Rosie O'Donnell and Louie Anderson.
All
please.
Right, that's wrong.
Please.
We are not going to send out a cursed script.
County pardon.
I watched them today, and he just, I feel bad when the family, when the families don't win, I feel bad.
Oh, isn't it the worst? Hey.
When the family wins, he dives out of the way. He leaves that stage.
Ah.
He doesn't want to be touched.
All right, we're going to take a break. We'll be back in just a second. More stuff on Run a Fez.
Run a Fez.
You're scaring me. Stop it.
1027 WNEW. 8 men. 1 machine. Tomorrow night, one man will finally settle the age-old battle of man versus machine. When all the flippers have stopped flipping and the bumpers stop bumping, one man will rise from the ashes as the victor. He will be crowned the champion over the fireball pinball machine. In the end, there will be only one.
Happens tomorrow on Ron and Fez.
It's going to be an exciting night, Fezzy. I love pinball. I love games where somebody walks away with everything and everybody walks away with nothing. Everybody else.
The everything is a fireball pinball machine from classicpinball.com. It will be delivered to the winner's house. This is a great machine. And, of course, the tournament will be played on our T2 machine out in the green room.
Did you see Ozzy's pinball machines in his game room?
Uh-huh. What did he have there?
I couldn't tell what it was, but it was set up like it was great, man.
Of course, they're throwing hams over the wall at people.
Well, sure they are. We got a situation here, Fezzy. We broke our curse, our intern curse, and actually hired a couple interns that looked like they were going to go all the way for us.
That has never happened to us. All the interns we've had on this show, none of them have been picked up by WNEW to get hired.
They were the pudding curse. You could call them the pudding curse.
And we had plenty.
Yeah.
And then finally we got two. We got Rachel, the Tenacious C.
Yeah.
And we got Wonderboy.
Now, just while we're bragging about that, Wonderboy goes AWOL this week. And Rachel, the Tenacious C, walked out on a drinking contest we had lined up for her last Friday.
So at that point, we got two interns that get hired, and yet we get left holding the bag. Excuse me.
Now, a real reflection of Al Dukes as well. Let's face it. He looks bad here. Mm. Here comes Wonderboy into the studio now. Not only, Fezzy, do we get him a gig, we also send him to spring break on a flight and back. And let's face it, got very little material out of it.
Yeah, got really nothing out of it. Got a two-minute horrible Tara Reid interview.
Oh, God, the worst I've ever heard.
And the assignment that we sent him on to get 50 pictures of topless spring break girls holding a Ron and Fez logo, that wasn't even attempted. That wasn't even bothered with while he was there.
Not a nip.
No. Well, I mean, we didn't get one picture. The kid never even hit the beach to try. He never even bothered trying to get the assignment done.
All right, so after being gone all week, here he is. It's Wonderboy.
Hey. I wasn't gone all week. I missed, you're right. I was gone for most of this week. Yeah, you're right. I thought you meant I was gone for a week.
You were gone all week,
you're right.
Is what
yeah.
I said.
Yeah, you're
today
right.
Is what day?
Today's Wednesday.
And when's the first time you showed up?
You're right, Wednesday. I misunderstood what you said.
So you've been gone all week?
Yes.
How are you keeping your gig here during the daytime?
Well, I was here for that. I was here for the one during the day.
You don't understand. You're here the whole time. How do you get away with this?
You have a gig with our show that you're obligated to.
Yeah, I had something happen personally that I needed a day or two off.
Oh, here we go. The personal thing. Now, Fez, all the years you've been on radio, how many personal days did you need to take off?
Let me try to count them up. No, none.
None.
Not one. Ronnie, how many personal days have you taken in our career?
Not one.
Right.
Babies are born, you go to work.
Right.
You got a funeral to go to, you still go to work.
Mm-hmm.
What else are you going to do? You took off two personal days and only told us about one.
Yeah, I meant to mention the other one.
Now, here's his... you mentioned it to Al.
No, I meant to, but then I left and I forgot to do that. So I told him about Monday. I told that Monday I wouldn't be here. And then Tuesday I meant to tell him that I hadn't gotten any
farther. So you said, I mentioned it to Al, and I go, oh, you mentioned it to Al, and you go, no, I meant to, but I didn't.
I mentioned the first one to Al. Monday I told him I wouldn't be here.
What did he say to you?
I don't know. He didn't seem happy, but he didn't say that I couldn't go. He just said, okay, so that's what you got to do.
All right, now, let me tell you what the personal thing is, Fez.
All right.
He broke up with his girlfriend.
Oh, you're kidding.
So every time...
Oh, you should take a month off, honey.
Every time you break up with your girlfriend, you should get a couple days off.
Well, we were living together. I was just trying to find a place to live. Like,
what happened?
Well...
At night? We're on at night.
Yeah, where are you finding places to live at night?
No, I was...
That's a good point.
I was looking in the afternoon. Like, after I left my other job here, I would try to get to somewhere to look at, like, apartments before they closed.
Where are you living? In the city?
Not right now, no. Right now, I'm still living at friends' houses, at assorted, like, whoever let me sleep over.
That's
at this
right.
point. But, so we were living together, and then when we broke up, I was trying to find a place to live. So that's why I wasn't able to be here yesterday.
It was her apartment this whole time?
Basically.
Why'd you guys break up? What happened?
Well,
because you were getting married.
Well, I was working a lot of hours.
Yeah, I kept hearing about this so-called fiance.
Yeah, right.
No, it was a real thing, but, you know, I was working a lot of hours, and then she didn't really like that. It wasn't really good for her. So, you know.
Oh, she'll be happy you're getting fired from two of your three jobs.
I have a lot more
Us, the dump button, and yeah, you'll have plenty of time with her.
Yeah. You should be able to move right back in. And keep your Jersey traffic gig, or whatever that is.
All right, let me bring Al Dukes in here. Let's see what we're going to do about you.
But the situation is, you didn't show up Monday, but you fulfilled another obligation, which I thought this obligation was first, and then yesterday, you didn't even bother with us at all.
Let me get Al Dukes.
I'm gay. I'm gay.
You can't come popping in here as gay as a cricket.
I'm gay.
All right, Al.
Hey, Al Dukes.
Hey.
What's the story on this kid? He told you Monday he was taking off.
Yeah, over the weekend I got an email requesting Monday off.
And that was okay with you?
Yeah, I mean, the guy's got a personal thing and he needs a day, I understand.
All right, every time you break up with a girlfriend, you get to take a day off.
No.
Did you get into it with what the personal day was?
No, he left in his email what it was, needed to find a place to live. And I
that apparently he's not taking her to prom and it was a really big emergency?
I mean, I'm like you guys, I don't take the personal days.
Please take one.
I know. God knows you don't take personal days.
You know what
days.
I want you to do? I want you to take off my personal days.
Nice. How many sick days do you have coming, Ronnie?
All of them.
That we can give to Al?
All of them.
I
you know what? If you're going to have the... I'll work through vacations as well if you'll take off.
As long as you're not here that way. Two birds, one stone.
What, is a job too difficult? What, you don't have enough experience? You're not smart enough?
Here's what I'm a big fan of, Al. You're taking the extended vacation.
No,
in which we now offer an extended vacation plan here at Ron and Fez.
No, when the show is on, I like to be here.
Oh, Jesus.
When the show's on, he's on, Ronnie. He's on.
I get it. All right, what are we going to do about this kid?
What would you say you do here?
Hmm? Al, what would you say?
Well, I'm not liking that he was rewarded with a pay job during the day for his internship work, and then he blows it off, especially to do traffic at stations no one's ever heard of in New Jersey.
Well, to give the listeners a little background, Al, tell me if I'm right or wrong here. I thought he got hired here at WNEW, but he was told his internship is his first obligation, and he has to fulfill that before anything.
Yeah, I was told his hiring, you're not even going to notice a difference.
Am I right there?
Yes, you are.
Who did you hear that from?
Craig.
So Craig went to you and said, hey, you've had this kid under your wing. Should we hire him?
No, he came to me after the hiring.
So you're nothing.
I was not in the loop.
You're not in management.
You're zero stroke here. The kid that you were supervising, they didn't even ask you, hey, how's he doing? Should we hire him? They just hired him.
Just hired him. And came to me after the fact. And I said, we still need him as an intern. They said, no problem. This is not going to affect the internship.
So what happened when you went back and said this kid missed 2 days in a row?
That it has obviously affected the internship and the obligation he has to us.
Craig got really red and embarrassed and said he would talk to him and that should not be the case.
Why don't you say, Craig, people like Mikey D, Dan from Hoboken, Pantera, all have expressed interest in being here at the station.
All have a desire.
And all have different skills and will show up. Why not talk to us before they do something so rash and crazy as to throw away a gig on somebody who every time he has a fight with a girlfriend doesn't show up to work?
On someone who's completely undependable.
Yeah, they should consider that.
How do we get into that loop?
I will put us in that loop.
It's too late now. The loop is gone.
The loop already went by.
Yeah, in this situation, it doesn't seem too late because
this kid's fired then?
Well, I don't have the power to fire him, but I certainly...
Why are we talking to you then? Why are we talking to the wrong person? IGVAC says he's in.
And GVAC.
What loop are you in? The Fruit Loop?
No,
is that you?
Normally I'm
You're that little cockatoo in the Fruit Loop?
Toucan Sam!
Normally I'm in the
is
loop.
Is that right, Toucan?
Toucan is Can Sam.
No, I'm normally in the loop in those
of
things.
Okay, so when Tenacious C got hired, they came to you and said, look, this young lady's been working for you.
No.
How's she doing? No.
I heard that that's on the air when you guys...
That's another loop. Toucan Sam didn't get part of.
You missed out on another Fruit Loop.
Right, after I had the discussion that I was left out of the loop the first time.
And immediately she gets hired, she was set up for a drinking game and misses it.
Yeah.
Yeah, she bails on us as soon as we need her to do something. As soon as she knows she's on the payroll.
Yeah, I don't know what's going on. I mean, this was supposed to be the good class of interns for the show. That's what I was hoping for. That's what it looked like halfway through the semester.
As soon as they got hired, this show got treated like crap.
Here's
and
what
ditched.
By the way, Fezzy, I just get this instant feedback.
All right.
F Me Boob says she'd gladly quit her day job to come work for us. Here's the help there. We'd get the F her boobs.
Right.
Not
she
only
F
would
she, me boob.
Not only would she be doing a good job, but finally we'd have somebody's boobs to F. Where Wonderboy, have we ever F'd your boobs?
No, I can't.
You're
say
useless. Never,
yes.
We could try the moles if we really wanted.
Not effing as moles.
F me moles.
You know what? Stop the mole thing. Let's get back to the business.
It's part, gross, right? And I'm obsessed.
But I know, but here's the thing. If you split, if they split us, Vince,
right,
then we got no power.
Okay, unified front.
Unified front.
Okay.
Al,
yes.
I want
jerk.
You, I want you to go in tomorrow, resign, and then on your way out, mention to them that they are going crazy hiring these interns that obviously aren't ready for real gigs yet.
Well, I don't want to resign, but I will talk to them about getting some of the fans of this show who do some work for this show on their own.
What we're looking here for is people that are ready to be in the pros. It's New York City. It's market number one. I don't know how many times I have to tell you that, Al.
Right, I understand that.
And we got people that are taking that opportunity and wiping with it because they had a fight with their girlfriend.
All right, let's bypass this. Wonderboy, I want you to go in tomorrow and resign.
Okay.
And open that spot up
for someone who really wants it.
By the way, remember we were talking about different promotional advice?
Right.
People got, more people have sent me magnets, Ron and Fez magnets, and this one, which I don't understand, it pops up constantly on my emails, water bottles. I don't know how hot they think people are listening to the show or how thirsty you get that you need to pump a water bottle down your throat.
No one's come up with can coolies?
Yeah.
Huh. That's got to be coming soon.
All right, this is on the instant feedback. This guy takes off 2 days for breaking up with his girlfriend. Ron never missed a day, even though he's got 5 abortions under his belt. That's true.
Literally.
And in every one of those cases, I drove and held hands afterwards.
And still made it to work and did the show.
And in 4 of the 5 cases, one of those kisses on the forehead.
Oh,
and
that's
the
nice.
Basic, I know, baby. I heard too. Believe me, I heard too.
But you're able to separate. That's the difference.
I separate. The second I get him out of the car, I forget about it. I forget it even happened.
I meant job and pleasure, but...
Oh, okay. All right, so that's the situation now. Nothing is going to come out of this again, right?
Well, my thing with this is if I'm having a discussion with Wonderboy and arguing what time he has to be here and when he can and can't be here, in my eyes, he doesn't want to be here, then why am I even arguing with it?
Oh, is that what you're saying?
No,
Wonderboy?
No, no, no.
You're
going to
leave now.
No, I
want to
be here.
I want you to leave now.
I want to work on your show, though.
Has Craig Schwab talked to you about this off?
Yeah, he did today.
What did he say to you?
He said that it's not going to fly, and that if I don't start...
And he's pretty fly for a white guy, but go ahead.
I'm all for letting the kid go. And Al, here's the what you said was just the biggest pussy. If he won't listen to me, what can I do? He would be gone.
Right.
Let him go. And then bust your ass and get him canned from the other jobs.
That's exactly what I would do.
Here's somebody who wants to work for us, this Ten Batsuin.
No, I don't want that guy in here.
He says he's
Why?
Been waiting tables, looking for a chance to get in the radio.
No,
I would love to have him in. That was the kid that was in the other night with Ice Cream Girl.
Oh,
no experience.
Yeah, he does. He's got a degree.
Yeah.
He'd be perfect for us.
He's got a radio degree.
Not to start in New York City.
Yeah, perfect.
All right, are you saying these other two lunkheads do? Our interns?
That I don't know. Not to start in New York City.
Remember when I used to put Wonder Boy at the top?
Oh, yeah. Boy, fell completely.
Yeah.
Fell right down.
Wonderboy
blew off the spring break assignment because I guess he knew he was getting hired.
Right. And getting high. Now, in the meantime, you were supposed to be Mr. Straight Edge.
Yeah.
And you wouldn't bang chicks because you had this girl you love so much.
Well, right.
Who's now kicked you to the curb, much like this radio station is about to do, I hope and pray.
Yeah, it hasn't been a good week.
I'd love to get rid of you.
But what if I just do a better job, though, and I promise that I'm going to show up every day and be, like, really on top of it, on the ball?
No. No.
You've shown zero respect for the show that got you in the door. And I'm saying that looking you right in the eye, serious as I can be. You've shown zero respect for the show that got you in the door. And as soon as you got on the payroll, you blew us off completely.
Right.
And if it was up to me, I would launch your ass today. I would have launched it Monday, actually.
Well, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to be disrespectful to you guys.
I say the kid doesn't have to come in anymore at night. I don't care what happens to him during the day, but why should he have to come in here at night? I mean, why be at a place where he's got a boss that surely can't handle him? When he's going, what can I do if he won't listen to me?
No, I'm
what
no.
can I do?
No, I'm it's saying if same. A guy's arguing with me saying, well, I'm too tired, I can't, then I don't want him. Why would I be arguing with the guy to get him to come to work?
No, you wouldn't argue him, but then you'd walk down the hall and make sure he's canned from the other job. And then you would say to him, I'm not going to argue with you, bitch. Don't show up tomorrow.
For any of it.
Here's what I think, too, Fez.
What's that?
Extended vacation for Al.
Oh, okay. Part of the extended vacation program.
You know, we must be tired. We're taking a four-day weekend because we're too tired. Why should I argue with somebody who won't listen to me? I'm not going to argue. They should listen.
After all, I'm middle management. He's an intern. Why would he listen to me?
You're not middle management. Al, get that through your head. Because they don't respect you.
I think they do.
Al, if you had any pull around here, this kid wouldn't be working here. He wouldn't be standing in the studio now, and he wouldn't have a job in the afternoon.
Yeah. I'm tired of talking about it. All right, so that's that. Let's move on.
877-692-1027.
What's the situation in New Jersey, Fuzz?
Now, this thing, I love Ronnie. Talk about extended vacation.
Yeah.
Ridgewood, New Jersey, they all got together, 30,000 residents there, and they took a night off. Ridgewood family night. Now, they arranged everything with the local youth activities, the sports teams there, everything else. Parents, kids, they all made the dedication, made the commitment to take a night off from everything. So no one had any homework to do. No one had ballet practice. No one had to get to any sort of sporting practice. There was no late night meetings, no homework. Families just spent the night together. Everyone took the night off in Ridgewood, New Jersey.
Who is this community, this Ridgewood, to tell people what to do with their time? Is it up to you how I enjoy spending my time?
This is the way it worked, Ronnie. It was, here's the slogan for family night. Ridgewood family night, ready, set, relax. Everyone took the night off.
Have they gotten a good look at these kids? It looks like they relax enough. I say put them on the track.
They're all getting fat letters, that's for sure. But they all took the night off.
I don't get it. I honestly don't get it. Fez. I don't understand what they're doing. So did it change things? Did it make things better in Jersey?
I guess everyone got to hang out together.
Yeah.
So I guess they're calling it a success.
Sure.
I know a lot of the hair salons didn't do big hairdos.
Really?
Hairspraying stopped in Ridgewood, New Jersey for one night only.
For one night only in Ridgewood, New Jersey, all the diners were closed.
Nice. For one night only in Ridgewood.
And Bruce Springsteen did not go out and jam with local bands at the Stone Pony.
Right. For one night only in New Jersey. I know the Sopranos did all their hits with silencers.
That's nice. Just and a
to
lot
keep
of time,
it quiet.
A lot of times they'll just use a pillow or a potato there, too, Fez.
Mm-hmm.
So there you go. Mm. All the toll booths on men.
Nice.
That one night. Unbelievable.
So it was very nice for a Ridgewood, New Jersey.
Nobody went down to the shore, as they say.
Really?
All the slot machines were put on silent mode.
Oh, so that's nice.
Is nobody wouldn't know. People were winning, you just didn't know it.
Nice and quiet. Frank Sinatra tunes turned off.
Finally.
Yeah. From Hoboken everywhere.
The 7-Elevens. Closed for just a couple hours.
Oh, okay. Right, yeah. Well, they had to take some time off.
No putting your Chevy El Camino up on blocks in your driveway. Just one night, get it off the block.
Oh, that's good. I know Italian grandmothers refrained from all self-pity and guilt trips.
Really?
For one night only in New Jersey, Ronnie.
Yeah.
One night only.
It's my kind of town.
Do you realize you're playing a song about Chicago?
Why did I get a Chicago song?
God.
Extended vacations all the way around.
We're taking a four-day weekend, Fuzzy.
Nice.
We're taking a four-day weekend.
All right. I know they stopped the Save the Stone Pony campaign for one night only.
Finally.
For one night only. They may have actually saved it. Maybe that's why they stopped.
Matt Tavoli.
The one-man campaign.
Yeah.
I know, Jersey Girls, quit being easy. For one night only, Ronnie.
Wow.
Bon Jovi fan since day one.
No, not that night, Eddie Trunk.
Bon Jovi fan since day one.
No, you give it a rest.
Bon Jovi fan since day one.
Everybody in Jersey, stop what you're doing for one night and rest. Hey, Kenny.
Jersey takes a night off.
Kenny, you're on Ron and Fez.
Are you starting this Dudley Moore thing again? Watch out.
That's a good point.
Oh,
you're
yeah.
You're just relaxing.
We're relaxing like they did in Ridgewood, New Jersey.
We're taking a time. You know, black guys, stop getting drunk and rob the Raw Way White Castle for just one night.
Oh, excellent.
They gave it a night off. I say take a rest. Actually, go to the rest area.
Oh, rest area? Rest.
One night only on the instant feedback. New Jersey State Police, stop racial profiling. Just one night.
There you go.
Just one night you let a black guy drive by without making a big deal out of it.
For one night only, no one went to the diner and ordered the happy waitress.
Right.
For one night only.
One night only.
That must have been nice.
Yeah.
Just to take some time off
in New
Jersey.
Take some time off. Make it a family night. Maybe one night without a mozzarella sandwich. One night only. Take a break.
It's not going to kill you to take one night only in New Jersey.
I don't see the problem there. How about one night only, the New Jersey terrorist? They stop making bombs. One night only, they go home, be with the family.
Nothing wrong with that for one night only in New Jersey. In Elizabeth, New Jersey, one night only, no one made up any excuses for the way the city smells.
That's nice.
There was no need.
Yeah. One night only. We shut the factories down. And just let things clean up. Just for one night only.
877-692-1027.
Taking the night off in Jersey, Jack. You're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, for one night only, you can drive down the Garden State and it doesn't smell like rotten eggs and farts.
That's one night only? That's all you're getting? You're getting one beautiful night only. Hey, Dan. Dan, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Dan.
Take a night off in Jersey.
One night only. Jason Williams didn't shoot anybody.
One night only, Fezzy.
We're limo drivers. We're safe.
One night only. Jersey's going to rest for a night. I don't see the problem with that.
Here's the thing. Go back to shooting limo drivers tomorrow.
You got it tomorrow. But for one night only.
One night only, New Jersey. Take a rest. From everything.
How about this? And one night only, Raw White Prison. You stop raping the new guys. One night only.
Nothing wrong with that.
Yeah.
They'll still be there tomorrow. One night only. The DMV inspection stations didn't fail all 9 out of 10 cars that came through.
Yeah.
One night only.
One night only. Hey, Warren. Warren, you're on Ron and Fez. Taking a little break in Jersey.
Hey, Warren.
Hey, one night only. Everybody in Jersey goes to the Vince Lombardi and gets some Jersey backhand. One night only.
Let's rest. Let's relax. Let's take one night for ourselves for Jersey. This one's for Jersey, Fuzzy.
One night only. The Newark Moss decided to stop the hate and embrace Whitey. For one night only.
One night only. What's the big deal there? You got to relax a little bit. Hi, you're on Ron and Fez. Hi, you're on Ron and Fez.
Yeah, hi, I got a one and only, one night only.
Yeah, go ahead,
buddy.
Sure, big ass card, 1993.
All right.
Hoo-ah, hoo-ah.
One night only, you can go through Newark, New Jersey without getting hit by by a carjacker.
All right, thank you very much.
No carjacking.
One night only, let's take a break for ourselves. Jersey Rich says one night only. Down at the shore, the ecstasy dealer stayed home. Just for one night.
That's all. That's all we're asking. One night with the fam.
We're raving tomorrow night. Hey, Brian, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, guys, one night only. Billy Staples' noise doesn't make any... Billy Staples' stomach doesn't make any stupid noises. And Ron and Fez don't get any callers who are idiots.
All right. Thank you very much. That's just one night only, Fez.
That's all we're asking.
Take a break from this noise from Billy Staples.
Ugh.
God, that's a stomach.
Ugh. Coming right through his chest.
Hey, John, you're on Ron and Fez, taking some downtime in Jersey.
Hey, what's up?
Yeah, John, go ahead, buddy.
Listen, for one night only, people let their Dodge Neons in the driveway.
One night only, leave them in. What's the big deal?
What's it gonna hurt if you take one night only in New Jersey?
Hey, Steven, you're on Mount of Fez.
Hey, Steven.
Hey, for one night only, them bastards will make you let you make a left-hand turn somewhere.
One night only.
Hey, and also, them parents, for one night only, they might not call the cops for me showing my thing to their little kids, you know?
Just one night only.
That's all we ask.
That's the only problem. Here's Tommy. Tommy from Mount of Fez.
Hey, Tommy.
Hey, Fez. For one night only, people from New Jersey can stop feeling jealous they're not New Yorkers.
Just one night? Relax.
That's all. One night only where you don't have to call him the New Jersey Giant.
Right. How about this? One night only. You guys don't bring up Kevin Smith to us, all right? One night only. We don't have to hear this song.
Smoking weed, smoking whiz. Doing coke, drinking beers. Drinking beers, beers, beers. Rolling baddies, smoking blunts. Who smokes the blunts? Who smokes the blunts?
One night only. Give us a break from that. Anthony, you're on Ron of Fez.
Hey, what's up, fellas?
Hey, buddy.
Buddy.
What? One night only. The A-Rabs. Stop selling bootleg Knicks jerseys on the PATH train.
Just one night. You take the PATH train and you go, no bootleg Knicks shirts. What's the big deal there, Fez? Take a break.
Nice. Take one night only and enjoy it.
Yeah. Hey, Dave. Dave, you're on the Ron of Fez show. How are you?
Hey, Dave.
Hey, guys. What's going on?
Hey, buddy.
One night only, girls in Jersey can stop using so much hairspray.
Just one night?
One night.
You go with soft hair.
One night only, you put down the can.
Yeah, you don't get it as hard. You don't have a hard hair. Have a soft one. Hey, Jerry, you're on Mount of Fez.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, Jerry.
One night only in Jersey, the bus going down Atlantic City didn't run off the road.
Is it so bad one night only, the bus driver stays awake?
And a bus doesn't turn over. One night only where you're not having to flip a bus right side up again.
Hey, Ozzy, you're on Mount of Fez.
Hey, Ozzy.
Card number 001.
Go ahead.
One night only, the priest leaves the little boys alone.
Just one night, Father.
That's it?
One night.
One night where someone doesn't have to go walking home bow-legged from church.
One night it is on Father Teabag dropping the kids off. Hey, Renzo, you're on Mount of Fez.
Hey, Renzo.
Hey, what's up? One night only, people from Jersey stop thinking they're in The Sopranos.
Yeah, for one night only, stop pretending that you're big pussy. Is that a problem?
Is that hard to do at all?
Hey, Brian, you're on Mount of Fez.
Hey, Brian.
Hey, one night only, the Jersey girls' poons don't smell like dead fish. Hey, Sherrod.
All right, Sherrod. But is that so much? Take one night and freshen up.
Yeah, one night. One night only.
One night. Hey, Tom, you're on Ron of Fez. It's Jersey time. We're taking a night off, like the good folks here.
Hey, Tom.
Hey, how you doing?
Yeah.
One night only. There's enough water in the reservoirs. You don't have to take four dumps in your toilet before you got to flush it.
All right. Thank you very much. One night only. Just relax from all the reservoirs.
A comfortable flush. One night only in Jersey.
Hey, John, you're on Ron of Fez.
Yeah,
hey, John.
One night only. You know, we don't have to listen to that crappy Bruce Springsteen anymore.
Just one night only. Just leave the Bruce away, all right? One night only, you don't bring up, hey, you know where I saw Bruce.
Right.
And have an interesting story. How about this? One night only, no Zubaz. Just take one night.
Would that
Zubaz
hurt?
Is that going to hurt you?
A Zubaz-free night.
Yeah. Here's, hey, Sean. Sean, you're on Mount of Fez.
Hey, Sean.
Elder 10-11.
Thanks.
How about one night
a
Jersey girl? No.
Just one night only. A Jersey girl doesn't feel she's got to bang everybody in the house.
Sure, just a little resistance.
Yeah.
One night only.
Is that a problem? Hey, Phil, you're on Ron of Fez.
Hey, Phil.
Hey, boys. Yeah. One night only. Maybe Stevie Van Zandt will take that do-rag off his head and relax a little bit.
One night only. Why air out the scalp a little bit and stop hiding everything with either a bad tooth or that do-rag? So what? You went through a windshield. Let it out there.
One night only.
Show your scar. Hey, Jason. Jason, you're on Ron of Fez.
Jason, what do you got, buddy?
I got one for you.
Yeah.
For one night only, the New York Giants and New York Jets. The New Jersey Jets. The New Jersey Giants!
All right, one night only. Let's let them have the title of their own stadium. Is that a bad deal? Here's Carl. Carl, you're on Ron of Fez.
Hey, Carl, go ahead, buddy.
Yeah, one night only. Jersey drivers know how to drive good.
Yeah.
Would that hurt? Would that hurt anything?
Yeah. Hey, Teddy. Teddy, you're on Ron of Fez.
Hey, Teddy.
Hey, one night only. All the gentlemen from Jersey put away their pocket pussies.
What? Now you just ball busted. Now you just ball busted. All right, Alicia says, one night only. All the boys in Jersey stop apologizing for getting off too quick. That's all. But Al backs that one up.
One night only with six bumps, maybe.
All right, C. America says, one night only. Al Dukes doesn't hit all the gay bars in Jersey after work. How about just taking one night off, Al? Can you do that?
Where you head home?
I know you are, but one night only. You rest. Hey, one night only. Dudley Moore dies in Jersey. Oh, that's
no, all Dolly. Right. All right. 877-692-1027. Ridgewood, New Jersey, taking a night off from everything for family night.
Yeah, I like it, Fezzy. Hey, Blake. Blake, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, Blake.
Well, here's Jeff. Jeff, you're on Run of Fez.
Blake, or Jeff.
Jeff, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, Jeff. Jeff.
1621. One night only. No U-turns.
No U-turns. One night only, Fezzy. And finally, here's Ted. Ted, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, Ted.
Hey, one night only. Everyone in New Jersey's got to pump their own gas.
Nice. Get out of the car. All right, there you go. Nice little bit there, Fezzy. That's another bit.
Yeah.
It's out of the way.
That's done. We crossed it off. We got a long weekend coming up.
We got a four-day weekend.
Oh, that's going to be nice.
Let me ask you this. Do the extended vacation people have a four-day weekend?
Let's give them, like, an extended weekend.
We keep on extension. They're on extensions the whole time. All right, well, let's take a break. We'll be right back. 102.7 WNEW. You're listening to Run of Fez.
Run of Fez. Frequency. 102.7 WNEW.
We're Run of Fez. Tomorrow we're giving out a Fireball pinball machine from ClassicPinball.com. The pinball tournament will be going on during the show tomorrow. 8 competitors going at it on our T2 pinball machine. Kevin from ClassicPinball.com, he's going to be here to officiate. One person's walking away with a $2,500 Fireball pinball machine.
Now this is going to be fun, Fuzzy. This is going to be exciting because you're looking at a chance to walk away with a pinball machine. Now, it's not always the kind of thing that you go out and buy for yourself. But anyone who's grown up in America has always wanted their very own pinball machine.
Well, you don't have to share it. You think about, you always have that place in your house where you think, pinball machine right there, something.
I always think of Joe Namath, because I saw pictures of Joe Namath's house years and years and years ago, and he had pinball machines. I'm like, that's got to be the coolest place of all time. Same with the Playboy Mansion. They would always show the pinball machine.
So that'll be going on tomorrow during the show, the Fireball Pinball Machine Challenge. 877-692-1027.
Now, if you have the chance to be off work for that, and why wouldn't you be? If you actually think about it, Fezzy, what do you think most people are doing as they listen to the show? Where would you put them at be?
I imagine them sitting in their homes, like surfing the web and stuff.
I think of a lot of people probably driving.
Okay,
I think a certain amount of people are also working the shift. Doing what? I don't know. Have you ever worked the second shift?
No,
I always found I've worked every shift before. Always the most annoying of all the shifts because you're not home for dinner. You're not home. You can't go to parties. Where if you work the third shift, you could leave the party early.
All right, and still make it into work.
Go to work drunk.
Yeah.
Second shift, forget about it. You're missing the happy hour. You're missing, you never see the evening news. The only good thing is you get to sleep in.
Yeah. You're going to work as it's getting dark. You're coming out, it's still dark.
But most of the time, for me personally, I have to be able to sleep in. All right, Nurse Myra just wrote to me on the instant feedback what she does during, and she says she runs a little girl batch. To the show.
That's how we picture most of the listeners.
That's how I picture Nurse Meyer anyway. I hope she comes in tomorrow. You know, we've asked so many people come in for your birthday. Not one reply.
We haven't gotten one RSVP for my birthday party tomorrow?
No. Not one. That's amazing.
Great. Well, happy effing birthday to me.
Yeah, well, I'm going to do what I can. I found out that there's a chance... That All right, FB says she's constantly touching herself, too, with her two-handed technique.
Well, it's nice to know so much batching's going on during the show. We must be doing something right.
Hey, Nick. Nick, you're on the Fez.
Hey, Nick.
Hey, how you doing, guys? Good evening. My name is Nicky. I'm from Montclair, New Jersey.
Yeah.
I work a four-hour shift as a baker. Come in, start around 6, turn you guys on at 7, listen to you the whole night. We have a couple of laughs. I enjoy your show more than anything.
All right, let me ask you this, Nick, and thank you so much.
Well, you're welcome.
But it's cool to picture you there. How come you only work a four-hour shift? The baker is like a specialty thing, or?
No, I'm the guy who mixes and shapes, and then I got two guys left behind me.
Yeah.
And they're going to finish off my job while I get to go out, like, around, like, maybe catch, like, go to a bar, see some ladies before I go to home, you know?
All right, so, but every day, all you work is 4 hours, and it's not like you got another job.
No. There are other days where, you know, it's like, right now, it's like Passover.
Yeah,
so
right.
We got all these specials and stuff.
Right.
So I got, like, hot cross buns for, like, Good Friday, and then coming Easter. And, 4 hours is, like, on, like, the low days, but this week it's going to be, like, maybe, like, 8.
And now, do you make good money as a baker?
I wish I could say yeah. But, you know, you start out, like, when you're right out of the school, and you get, like, $9 an hour.
Yeah.
Which is decent when you're just, like, coming out of, like...
If you always work as a baker, you can always work for the rest of your life, right?
Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah, because they're always looking for a good baker.
Damn right.
Hey, Nick, thank you so much.
Pastries.
Gentlemen, thank you very much.
So that's the thing to understand, Fezzy. Most people are baking bread.
Oh, okay.
Why they listen to our show.
So far, either girl batches or bread baking.
Sometimes even that specialty two-handed technique.
All right. So far, both involve yeast.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. So that's what most people do during our show. Hey, Paul, you're on a Fez.
Hey, Paul.
What's up, guys?
What do you do during a Run a Fez show?
I listen to you guys as a bar hopping.
Really?
Funny enough, you get funnier as I get more drunk.
That's the great thing. I wonder how many people are DUI and why they are listening to the program.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Hey, I always got it designated.
Where are you at, Paul?
I'm out on Long Island.
Okay.
All
right.
So as you go from bar to bar and every time as you listen to the show, as the night progresses, as you're drinking, we get funnier.
Yeah.
I like the thought, Fezzy, and we get a lot. Thank you very much. We get a lot more of this on Friday. Very drunk nights. Very drunk phone callers.
And they start early.
Yeah.
They start coming in because people have obviously started their weekends before we started this show.
You hit the happy hour, and by the time it's 7 o'clock, you're giving a, hey, what are you guys, the fag? And we always know. We don't need a calendar. We know it's Friday. I had something to tell you, but I forgot.
All right. So this is very informative because so far we've gotten the Batcher, the Baker, and the Bar Hopper.
Right. Let's go to Dylan. Dylan, I hope it's Bob. You're on Fez.
Hey, guys.
Or at least Thomas.
You guys, it's obvious. Everybody's sitting home drinking beer, smoking pot.
Now, there are quite a few people I know, and that's what you pretty much think of it as.
That's how I picture it.
Yeah.
Feed up.
Yeah.
That's it.
Now, I think out of all the shows, we get more drunk people.
Oh, by far.
And we definitely get more stoned people.
Yeah, we're leading the league there.
Yeah.
In the partiers.
Which I wish there was some kind of a thing on the books for that. I mean, that's why Sam Adams wants to do our show, because they know people are thinking, what am I going to drink next? That was Sam Adams.
Nice frosty spring ale for yourself.
All right, here's Aaron. Aaron, you're on Ron Fez. We're kind of doing a little poll here. And you can sit in a pool while you're doing it. We're asking people what they do during our show. We've never asked that before in all the time we were doing this, Fez.
So, it's just a chance to get to know you.
Aaron, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey, Aaron.
Ron Fez, what's up, fellas? I'm an ambulance driver. I listen to you guys all the time.
An ambulance? Is that like a really small ambulance?
Nah, an ambulance is for non-emergency transportation, like invalids and dialysis patients, things like that.
And a lot of that going on at night.
Oh, yeah. I mean,
even though it's not emergencies, there's still a lot of transport going on.
Absolutely. I mean, I start work at 3 o'clock, and I end my day at 12, so I hit ONA, and then you guys, and it's perfect.
All right, thank you very much. There you go. Mm-hmm. Fezzy, I told you we get a lot of amulet drivers. I've told you that before.
You have?
Yeah, I said, let's try to do more amulet material. All right, here's Chris.
I got to listen better.
Yeah, here's Chris. Chris, you're on Run a Fez.
Hi, Chris.
Hello?
Yeah.
Hey, what's happening, guys?
We're just hanging in here today.
Yeah, I killed time listening to your show during NA meetings and stuff.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Not really paying attention and stuff.
So you go into your NA meeting with headphones on?
Yeah, those little ones that you put in your ear.
Right.
I just leave it on the right side where he can't see it.
All right, the only thing I worry about is that you're not going to get the most that you should be out of the meeting itself.
And usually we're talking about things that are just leading you in the wrong path.
Right. Not that you're not a big person. You can't do what you want. I don't want to chase anyone away, but, you know, try to pick up something there. Okay, Chris?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Good.
Right. Thanks.
If you're making the effort,
yeah.
Anyway.
Yeah. Unless you're being forced in, then. Chris, you're on Run of Fez.
Hi, Chris.
Yeah, hey, what's up, guys? How you doing? Yeah. I haven't talked to you in a while.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm on the road.
All right, you're driving around?
I'm on the road every night when I listen to you. I work the night shift. I do drain cleaning.
All right, so while you're in the car or van, I guess you're listening to us.
Yeah, so I get the customers trying to chew me down, and I got to see toilets filled up. You guys keep me laughing.
They try to Jew him down, Fezzy.
I didn't say that.
I don't know what that means over Passover.
Passover starting tonight. Happy Passover,
you
everyone.
You said chew me, right?
No, I didn't.
What did you say?
Chew.
Yeah. They're physically chewing you down.
Yes.
All right, my friend.
I enjoy that.
Thank you very much.
Okay, have a good night, guys.
Thank you.
Here is Jeff. Jeff, you're on Run of Fez. How are you?
Hi, Jeff.
What's up, fellas?
Hey, buddy.
2732 checking in.
Hi, my man.
I start you guys at work, and then I come home, roll myself up a fatty, put on a little hockey, basketball, or wrestling.
Yeah.
Put my headphones on and listen to you guys.
You know, good point, because when you watch sports, if you're an adult, you don't need anybody explaining the game to you.
Or, exactly.
And you also, with those guys, you know, if it's football, you're only getting 16 games a year. You got to watch every minute. Well, the four-hour baseball game, the last thing you need is your full concentration. You should
right.
be doing at least two or three things during a baseball game. I try to anyway. All right, thanks a lot.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks, right. Jeff.
All right, here we go. All right, now we're picking things up, people. You're smoking pot. You're doing some work.
Now we're finally starting to understand.
Yeah. All right, Mike. Mike, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, Mike.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey.
Go ahead, Mike.
Yeah, I listen to you guys while I'm driving around looking for my girlfriend in bars.
She's out with other people?
Nah, she's out there hiding in the bars. I find her, and then we have a good time in the parking lot afterwards.
Right. So
that's a game you play?
Yeah, most of the time he's third or fourth.
It turns into a game. Yeah, it's kind of like a new sport.
All right, my friend.
Batching in the parking lot.
There we go. All right, well, you know. Not everybody wants to get a hotel room. Hey, Frank. Frank, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, Frank.
Yeah, how you doing, guys?
Yeah.
What's going on tonight?
Well, we're just
trying
to find out what everybody's doing during the show.
Yeah, well, I drive to work at this time. I work 10 to 6 for the Transit Authority right down the block from you guys. I'm at 57th and 8th Avenue.
Oh, you ought to stop by sometime.
I'm waiting for you.
Yeah.
See me?
Yeah, I just got off the phone with Nurse Meyer. She's a tenant of mine.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, she told me that she'll be at your party tomorrow.
Oh, that's one, Fezzy.
Just to let you know, she'll be there.
All right. Now, also, she said that she touched.
Then why hasn't she RSVP'd?
I don't know.
I'll talk to her tomorrow. I'll ask her. But I just got off the phone with her while I was driving on the West Side Highway, and she told me that she was going to your radio show tomorrow.
Hey, is she hot or what?
I don't know if my wife's listening. I can't say anything right now.
All right, just cough, okay?
No, but yeah, she'll be there. I just wanted to tell you guys I listen to you on the way to work every night.
Thanks, Frank.
Yeah.
And you're doing a good show.
All right.
Frank's a nice person. Sounds like he's just trying to make me feel better.
I would hate to be in the kind of relationship where you couldn't say whether another woman was hot, though. I really...
Or even cough.
Hey, is that, Halle Berry attractive? I can't say I'm married. So there's no way I can tell because I'm married.
Her dress should have won the Academy Award.
Ellen? Maribel. Okay.
Hi, Maribel.
Sorry. Hi, what's up, Ron and Fez?
Hey.
What can we do for you, sweetheart?
I have a very boring job. I sit at a desk crunching numbers for a bank, and I listen to you guys, me and my friend. That's it.
Now, the banks aren't all closed by now? I mean, I know you're working after hours, but...
Yeah, it's not for the bank. It's like the central office or something. We get all the checks from the branches, and we put all the little black numbers at the bottom.
Just the black numbers?
Yes.
That's racism, Fezzy.
It's check profiling is what it is.
Yeah. All right, what time do you get out?
Oh, we get out, like, I just got out a little while ago. between 9, sometimes 10, sometimes 11.
And what time do you start work?
I start at 3.
All right, so we have a fair amount of people working, Fezzy, and a fair amount of people partying. Thank you very much, honey.
All right.
Bye-bye. See you.
Thanks, Maribel.
Here's George. George, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, George.
Yeah, what's up, guys? Yeah.
Go ahead, buddy.
Yeah. I'm working as a security every day, 4 to 12, and we are Russians, all Russians, and all of you, all of us listen to you day.
All right, Fezzy, we're big with the Russians, and I told you we were.
Every day.
Told
there's
you,
like 20 of us here, and we love you guys. It's a good show, great show, and every day we listen to 4 to 12 every day.
I always tell Fezzy, he doesn't understand times. Mm-mm. I always tell, four, I guess, in the afternoon until 12 at night, so he starts with them when I work for us. I always tell Fezzy, we got to do more Chernobyl material.
That, and George, we've been really trying to book Yakov Smirnoff.
Constantly.
Going out of our way. We
in
have
this country, government works for you. And I don't understand that.
What a country!
That's actually not a bad impression. All right, thank you, George.
We've got calls into Branson, Missouri.
All right, so we're big with the Russian mafia, which is great. Hey, Mark. Mark, you're on Run of Fez. How are you, my friend?
Hello, Mark. You there, Mark?
Hey, guys. Cardholder 10577.
All right.
How are you, my friend?
Hoo-ah!
Hey, how you doing? I leave Manhattan about 6:45. Listen to you guys from 7 to about 8:30, and have dinner, get back into bed, listen to you before I go to sleep.
All right.
So
now,
you got a commute, is what you're saying?
I got to listen to you during the commute.
All right. Now, how far of a drive is that?
That's about an hour and a half, hour and 45 minutes.
All right. Thanks a lot. Hey, now we're learning things, Fizzy. We should be doing more commuting material.
Okay, yeah.
I'm always telling you that we should be talking about cars more.
Mm-hmm.
We should be doing something.
How about those drink holders in cars?
Right. You ever notice them?
You can't put a really big gulp in there or anything, can you?
You can't be drinking a gallon of milk.
No. They need gallon holders.
All right, we're going to work on that.
Yeah, we'll get there.
Yeah, I mean, we'd like to just improvise it. Here's Mark.
Hey, Mark.
What's up, guys?
Yeah.
Doing the drinking, smoking, playing a PlayStation.
All right, well.
I'm taping the show, by the way.
Good. What are you going to do with the tapes?
I sent them down to my brother. It's in Florida.
What part of Florida?
St. Petersburg.
Oh, nice. Sorry.
And my mother just sold her house in Pinellas Park.
All right, also, Fezzy.
Pinellas Park, Florida.
Also, I'm cleaning my oven.
All right, so.
Okay.
You're getting high, you're playing with chemicals, and you have a kid's game. All right.
So you're all set. Nice.
Hey, Macy, you're on Manifest.
How are you guys?
It's Macy Gray, Fezzy.
Hi, Macy Gray.
How are you? I haven't talked to you in a while. I've been busy.
How are you, Macy?
Good. How are you?
You know, we get so many celebrities. We get Stephen Baldwin, Macy Gray, and Elmo.
I just want Fez. I'm going to call in tonight and sing to you tomorrow.
Oh, for his birthday.
Oh, thank you.
Okay, and this is what I do is I shave my down south afro.
All right, please. That's
I'm going to Macy Gray style. See ya.
All right, she's shaving the down south afro.
Yes,
during
sure.
the show. And we're only on 4 hours. So
she's got to do it every night. Just to basically stay even.
To stay ahead of the game.
I wouldn't say ahead. I would say even most days. But if she missed a day, Fezzy.
Like a controlled burn, like they do with forest fires.
If she missed a day, she'd never be able to put her pants on.
877-692-1027.
Hey, Dino. Dino, you're on around a Fez.
Hey, Dino.
500.
Hoo-ah!
What's up, Dino?
Not much. I'm a lifeguard from 3 to 10, and basically I just listen to you guys all day.
Now, what is this, an indoor pool?
Yeah, it's over here on the east side. It's a Manhattan condominium.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
And so you got to be on duty. Is there a lot of times where there's just nobody in the pool? You're just sitting there?
Sitting there and falling asleep.
How many people do you normally get in the pool at any time?
Most to the max, about 6.
Wow.
And all of them are all Russians, and like, say, from the Czech, because the UN is right over here.
Yeah, well, we're very big with Russians. We found that tonight.
Yeah, we learned that. Have you ever had to save anyone at the condo pool?
Well, it's 4 feet deep, and if they drown, you know, they deserve to drown in 4 feet of water.
You got a nice job, my friend.
All right, here's Tracy. Tracy, you're on the Fez.
Tracy. Okay.
Hello.
Yeah.
Hi, I tape your show every night, the whole thing.
Uh-huh.
And then I listen to it during the day when I work.
What kind of job do you do?
Well, I drive all day. I do pharmaceutical sales, outside sales.
You know, so did I. I used to do pharmaceutical sales.
Oh, yeah?
I freelanced. I
also at night.
So you guys get me through the day.
What can you bring by for free for us? You got any free stuff to give out?
I can get you some meds, Ronnie.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hold on, because I really, seriously, I'd like to start. I'm trying to meet new people, and I like to hang around with you.
Okay, well, we'd have to talk off air, you know?
Yeah, all right.
All right.
Okay. How's it going with the show? I got to talk to somebody.
Nice. And she also does voiceover work for Betty Boop cartoon.
Tracy, get me the blue ones. If it's blue, I want it.
Are you done?
Hey, Jeff. Jeff, you're on Run-A-Fest.
Hey, Jeff.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey.
All right, during the day from 5 to 9, I work at Chinese food place. I deliver it in Staten Island, right by the garbage dump. Oh. Oh, that just almost killed me.
Chop-a-chop!
I feel like we do plenty of Chinese jokes, so you're fine with that.
So we got him covered.
Yeah.
He didn't even sound Chinese.
A lot of people driving around, though, Fezzy. Hey, Nick. Nick, you're on Run and Fez.
Nick.
Hello. Yes, Run and Fez.
Yes, sir.
I drive a cab, man. I listen to you guys every day.
Where are you driving a cab at?
I drive in Manhattan, yellow cab.
You ought to swing by here and pick us up one night.
All right. All right. Sure. What time you get off?
You know, normally, well, you know, what time are we off normally? 11:02?
Yeah.
Yo, I'll pick you up any day, man. No problem.
All right, well, hang out one day.
I drop you for free.
No, that you don't have to do that, my friend.
I would like
to know the cab driver. I wish I had the same cab driver every night.
That would be fun.
You know, we could just sit around and talk about what kind of day we had. And it would be fun.
Did the passengers like it, Nick?
Oh, yeah. Sometimes they tell me to shut it off. But
yeah,
you know,
sure.
Yeah, but these guys, man, I hate them.
Half the time I'm in the studio, I'm trying to shut it off. I try to turn off my headphones.
All right.
I see it.
Thanks a lot. Nice talking to you guys.
Nice talking to you. All right, people do all kinds of things, Fezzy. They're doing all kinds of things.
We're trying to figure them all out.
It's not like we can really start to aim these things. Al, you're on Run and Fez.
Hello, Al.
Hi, this is Al.
Yeah?
Well, I like to count Tic Tacs during a show and dream about hot men is.
I'm gay.
That's right. I'm gay. Right.
Thank you, Al.
Call Alan, okay?
You can't come popping in here as gay as a cricket.
I'm gay. I'm gay.
You can't come popping in here as gay as a cricket.
I'm gay. I want you to do me a favor. I never again want you calling from the other room.
Why are you calling the show from the other
room? You can't come popping in here as gay as a cricket.
That was somebody pretending to be me.
No, that was you. I'd know you anywhere.
We traced the call. It's coming from inside the studio.
No. How you doing with the intern, Jay? Able to get that straightened out?
Yeah, we're working that out.
Still?
The intern tried to talk to me during the break. I go, I'm not talking to you. He goes, you seem like you're really disappointed. I go, not with you. I'm disappointed now. I'm not going to sit around talking to the interns about whether I'm disappointed with them or not.
They're inconsequential.
That's Al's business. Nurse Myers coming in tomorrow. That girl. When's the last time we saw her?
That is a good question.
You know what I want to do? I want to play solitaire on her ass tomorrow.
We'll
just have a relaxing night of cards and do all 52 cards. See if I can get them all.
Just you and her playing solitaire.
On that big Russian ass. Well, no, she's not Russian. What is she?
Serbian.
Yeah, like there's a difference.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's all
right.
Satellite nations, Ronnie.
Yeah,
please.
Thank you. Jessica, you're on Manifest.
It's all the CCCP. Hi, Jessica.
I don't know what that means.
Hi.
USSR in Russian.
I don't get that either. It's just almost crazy.
Go ahead, Jessica.
Hi. I work in a group home. I listen to you guys.
What kind of group home?
It's adults with mental disabilities and developmental disabilities.
Hold on. One of them wants to get on the phone. You'll be back soon.
So every time you guys say retarded, I have to say, oh, no, not you guys.
Oh, yeah, we don't mean them. We mean other retards.
No, not your retard. No.
So what's that like for you, though?
I am not a retard.
No, we know.
Now they're just screaming.
It's a little crazy here.
Yeah.
But yeah, we love you guys. They like to listen to you.
Really?
Yeah, they do.
They find our voices soothing?
Yeah, puts them right to sleep, thank God.
So what do you do there? Are you just making sure no one goes out the door?
Yeah, we you know, dispense meds. We make sure no one starts hitting each other, you know.
Can you give me the blue ones?
We're finding out a lot of the listeners work directly with meds.
All right, Jessica, get me the blue ones, okay?
Okay.
All right, talk to you soon.
Okay.
Bye, Jessica. Thanks for the call. Jesus. I work in a group home with a mentally disabled, and then laughs. 877-692-1027.
Hey, Pat, you're on Ron Fez.
Hello, Pat.
Hey, Ron Fez, what's happening?
Hey, my man.
I drive a gas trailer during your show.
Wow. See that, Fuzzy?
That's hard work. That's dangerous.
People do all
different things. Yeah, definitely dangerous.
All right, thanks a lot. Here's Tom. Tom, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey, Tom.
Yep, I worked at Meadowlands Racetrack.
You know who I want to start racing? My partner, Fez.
Yeah?
He is surprisingly quick for a guy of his stature.
Put him in an exacta with Joe Fu.
Who?
Put him in an exacta with Joe Fu.
I'm not familiar with who you're talking about.
Oh, racetrack talk.
All right.
Oh, that's the exacta we know.
Yeah, the exacta part we got. All right, thanks a lot. Exactly.
Exactly right.
Yeah.
Thanks for the call.
Here's Jason. Jason, you're on Run and Fest.
Go ahead, Jason.
Hey, guys. I'm a supervisor at night. I drive around 8 hours a night, and you guys get me through it every single night.
So you're going around checking on guys at other jobs?
In Manhattan, yeah. I drive pretty much all of Manhattan. Yeah.
What are you supervising?
We finish metal, different entrances, and we do your building, too, I think.
Really? The 888 yeah. building on 57th Street?
No, the one right next door to it,
oh,
I think.
Okay. You know what? I'd love to get a big sign one night since we're here. We're like the last people.
The Ron and Fez sign.
Yeah, but just a big Ron and Fez so when people come in the morning, they just see that.
Where the you old should have something like that. We'll just hang it right over to the 888 part.
Yeah, that would be hysterical. All right,
they won't even know who it is.
Yeah, they won't know.
Love you guys.
All right, thank you, my friend.
Meet me at the Brooklyn Diner. It's right there at the foot of the Ron and Fez building.
Mm-hmm. Here's Tina. Tina, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Tina.
Hi, guys.
Hey.
Go ahead, sweetie.
I was just calling to let you know that you guys keep me up on my long ride home from work every night.
Now, how far you got to drive to get home?
About an hour and a half.
Wow. Where do you work and where do you get home to?
I work for the railroad. I'm a train engineer, and yeah. I live on the other side.
Do you get to take that train home at night?
No.
Thanks.
I wish.
Now, if I was working for the railroad, but it was all the livelong day.
Oh, yeah. Just to pass the time away?
Yeah.
Wow.
Can't you hear the whistle blowing? All right, thanks, Tina.
I'll blow the whistle for you guys.
Yeah, well, I was so disappointed when you said whistle. I never felt quite so disappointed. You got it now, right, Tina?
Thank you.
All right, bye,
you know
honey.
What I mean.
Be safe driving home.
All right.
Unbelievable, Fez.
This is nice, getting to know the listeners a little bit
yeah,
more.
Yeah, finally.
Finally figure out what everyone's doing out
Let's
there.
Let's break down this fourth wall. Have you ever noticed how people keep saying break down the third wall? I hear
that's
that everywhere.
Wrong.
They keep saying they're breaking the third wall, and I'm going, why would you break that wall? That's the side wall.
That's just a nice side wall. There's nothing there.
You break the side wall, and you got nothing happening.
No, just signs there. There's not even really a lot of room to stand over there.
So remember that, folks. That, and here's another thing. If I get another email that spells lose, L-O-O-S-E, I'll go crazy.
Yeah.
They always tell me,
loose.
Al is a looser. And I'm not kidding you. It's the most common mistake.
There's one O in loser and lose, people. Throw in another O, it's loose.
I just got an email from Myra. She can't make it.
Oh, man. She was the one that I had.
Let's do this. Let's cancel your birthday for tomorrow, Fez, since no one can make it.
Why?
And what I'll do is get you something extra for Christmas.
No! Christmas is forever away!
I should take you out to dinner tomorrow.
Oh, that'd be nice.
Want to do sushi?
Oh, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Make the nice sushi. Why don't you go for the record tomorrow?
For the record? Oh, God.
You know what?
It almost killed me.
You know what? I never even realized this. On my refrigerator, I have a picture of you and my kids. And I notice that was a night that you ate the 52 pieces of sushi.
Yeah.
I just figured that out the other day. I'm going, why is there a 5 and a 2 up?
Well, holding our hands up, making the number. Because it's always like, what was it? Was it 42? Was it 62? What was it? You know, something like that. And then it's in the picture.
I don't even think you can do that anymore.
I don't think I am nearly in sushi eating shape to pull that one off. And then I think it almost killed me.
Oh.
I started to bloat and swell.
Hey, Myra actually wrote this in. Nurse Myra, who I know her landlord very, very well.
Oh, really?
And he doesn't want to comment on what kind of ass she has. Nurse Myra said she will come in if, provided, she can give Fez a lap dance.
A lap dance?
Yeah. Lesbo sex.
Ronnie, you know I don't munch.
I know you don't.
I am no lesbian. Huh.
You don't want it, huh? All right, we're back to zero. We're back to zero.
Huh.
Why don't you just try 50 pieces of sushi tomorrow?
Eh, we can work on it.
Listen, when I take you out to dinner tomorrow, you mind if Wonderboy comes along?
Yes, I do.
For your birthday.
No, I don't want Wonderboy at my birthday dinner. He stinks.
All right.
Are you getting a mole roll? I think not on my birthday, my friend.
How many people are going to get the mole roll joke? The kid has a lot of moles on his back.
He's covered.
And sushi
is freakish.
Sushi is called rolls, so Fez is going, what are we getting a mole roll?
Getting a teca mole?
Right, so you don't want him to come?
No, I don't want him at my birthday party.
Can I bring out Dukes?
No.
All right.
Jeez. I feel like I was having my birthday dinner at that group home that Jessica called about.
I am not a retard.
Jeez.
Can I bring Craig?
Do you have to? For what reason in the world would you have to bring Craig Schwab?
To sit across from you.
No. I went to the doctor's the other day. I walk in and he comes in the lobby.
Yeah, right. You and him both had the same drip.
And I was at the gyno. It was very weird.
What about Superstar? You want to go out there? You want him in?
I am not a retard.
I haven't seen Superstar in months and months.
How about Rudy? You want Rudy to stop by?
No, I don't want Rudy.
Cecilia up in Human Resources?
She needs to clean her office is what she needs to do and not worry about birthday dinners.
All right, then the only person coming in is Tasteless Ginny.
No!
Hey,
birthday isn't even worth celebrating.
I got an email from somebody who wants a job with us. Again, everybody always wants a job with
us. Sure.
But says that they are Tasteless Ginny's daughter's boss. And she's really, really cute now. We haven't seen her since she was a little girl.
Yeah, Tasteless Junior.
Yeah, Tasteless
Junior. Is what we called her.
Right. Hawk's friend.
Right.
And supposedly is really, really adorable now that she's older.
We have to meet up with Tasteless Junior again.
Bring her in with Nurse Myra one night. Introduce her to the dark side. Is Jenny liking it?
Yeah, and shaking her head no.
Yeah, just let her come in for a lights out party, Jenny.
Yeah.
No, I don't think I could bear watching that.
Do you know who her boss is?
Well, she has two jobs.
Oh, okay.
She has two jobs, and she goes to college.
Right.
Dang.
Yeah, how about helping her out a little bit? Is that a problem?
Do you mind? Golly, so she can quit taking in wash?
Was one of them kind of production related or anything?
No, she works in two restaurants.
Oh, yeah. All right. Okay. I can't think of who it was. Somebody, I think maybe I have the letter down there. But anyway, says she works with, says she's really cute now that she's older.
She is a very cute young lady, yes.
Nice. Congratulations. So you don't want her to come in and meet Nurse Myra and all the...
Well, she can come in and help you guys out, but I
don't think
I
don't like Nurse Myra and all the girls.
She's my baby.
I know. But I'd love to see her dancing. I think it would be fun to break her in the radio.
And Tasteless Ginny, you're here late on Friday night. You know how well the lights out parties go.
You know that's no problem. You know nobody.
As the sun's coming up and Ginny goes, you're still here?
Oh, jeez.
Yes. I do it every Saturday morning. Are you still here?
Even Piazza's disgusted with you.
Well, you think about that. The invitation's open to Tasteless Junior.
Seriously.
Okay, I will.
She ever wants to come in and be a vampire?
and be a vampire.
Seriously, we're having a Dawn of the Dead party coming up real soon.
Nice.
All right. Well, I don't know. One of those guys is our boss, so I was going to turn that over to Al. When we get a chance.
She'll never get in here then.
Who's that?
Oh, we give it to Al?
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Al, nothing gets done, Dukes. It all gets done eventually, just poorly.
Yeah, poorly and without reason. I saw him actually take a post-it and stick it to his forehead today.
And it said, remember to tinkle.
No,
that's what it actually said.
He had one that said, when I get home, sit my dad's D. And he just placed it to his head.
I always wondered why every Wednesday is circled on the calendar.
That's it.
That's D-Sipping Wednesday.
Yeah.
All right, it's Hump Your Dad Day. All right, now I understand.
Which, by the way, that D-Sipping Wednesday, I think Scott Shannon started years ago, back when he was in Memphis. And now it's everywhere. All right, we got to take a break, Fizzy.
877-692-1027.
When we come back, we'll teach you how to annoy famous people.
Oh, all right. Yes, we will.
Which is somewhat of a hobby of Fez and I. You don't want to miss this.
It's the best thing in the world.
And after that, Fez will eat 52 pieces of sushi.
53 for the record.
Oh, man, you know what? I ate garlic powder tonight.
Oh, huge. That's no good.
Why didn't I just put acid? Why didn't I eat two hits of acid?
We'll just get a Sears Ever Ready and dump the acid on it.
But you know what? I swear. No, I was actually talking about LSD because I'll be up all night hallucinating from garlic powder. I might as well have snorted it. Jenny, eat a piece of pizza.
Please.
If that'll help you bring your dog.
Plenty
in.
There.
And by the way, before you say no, we're getting a pole in here to dance on.
Right.
So it's up to you.
One of those where the water bubbles inside it.
Everything's going to be classy.
Isn't that yellow pole over there with the marks on it?
Yeah, that's the... That's yeah, the don't want to touch
that.
Don't touch that. The FCC wants that.
That's an evidence case right
yeah,
now.
Actually, make sure my fingerprints are anywhere near it. We'll take a break. We'll be back. Ron and Fez.
Ron and Fez, 1027 WMEW.
Ron and Fez here, telling you about New York Health and Racquet Club's 8th and largest location at 23rd and 6th. It's the new grand opening.
Right, it is. Billy Staples walks in during a live read and turns off the lights.
Why we're reading a commercial? Turns off the lights like an idiot with his fat back.
Why would he do it?
Then, immediately turns them back on and hits the switch so hard that they come on blinding you at full light.
And this is why he wants to get off his extended vacation. You're drunk, Billy. The
what a maniac.
New York Health and Racquet Club, Fezzy, nothing like him. Impeccably maintained indoor pools, steam rooms, oversized Turkish rock saunas. And soothing mineral whirlpool baths. Now, here's the great news, Fezzy, and I know a lot of guys worry about this. No long-term contracts. It's all pay-as-you-go. I'm not making that up. It's pay-as-you-go, no long-term contracts.
So join now at any HRC location, and during March, you get very special grand opening prices to celebrate HRC's brand-new 40,000-square-foot super club at 23rd and 6th in Chelsea. Give them a call, 1-800-HRC-BEST. That's 1-800-HRC-BEST, or log on to HRCBEST.com today. New York Health and Racquet Club.
Even with the lights off, Fezzy and I can tell you, there's nothing like the New York Health and Racquet Club. Consistently voted Manhattan's best health club.
New York Health and Racquet Club.
Ron and Fez. Frequency. 1027 WNEW.
In the world of light and sounds, beepers and bumpers, young and old will compete for the grand title. All will be in competition for the grand exalted title of the Pinball Wizard. Tomorrow night, the best of the best will be brought together for the Fireball Pinball Machine Tournament. And let the games begin.
On tomorrow's show, someone's leaving with a Fireball Pinball Machine from ClassicPinball.com. We're running Fez.
Fez, that was actually wrong. We don't have 8 men. We have 7 men. 1 woman.
Oh, could this be a wild card in the Fireball Pinball Machine tournament?
I'm also wondering if she'll show up. This is like
someone may draw a bye.
This is like that Heart Like a Wheel movie where the girl wanted to race drag race. Remember her? What was that woman's name? The first lady drag racer. She, I knew this. She was up against Big Daddy all the time.
Dan Garlitz?
What the hell was her name? I'll think of it later, I guarantee you. It's 877-692-1027. We are trying to put together this birthday party for Fez.
Well, my birthday is Sunday, and tomorrow night's our last night on the air before the big long weekend.
Yeah. The strange situation is we finally got an RSVP. It's Earl Douglas plus two. So
plus two?
Yeah.
Dang, black girl.
Shirley Muldowney, thank you very much.
Shirley That's Muldowney. The guest he's bringing?
Cha-Cha Shirley Muldowney, that was her name.
The lady drag racer.
You don't remember Cha-Cha Fuzzy?
No, I don't know Cha-Cha Muldowney.
Cha-Cha Shirley Muldowney. And in that movie, that was a cool movie. Heart Like a Wheel, I think was the name of it.
This I gotta check out now.
Yeah. Came out like a long time ago, like in the 80s, I think.
Right now, all I got for my stupid birthday is Black Earl.
Plus two.
I don't even know who the two are.
Oh, guess who's saying hi to you, too, on the instant feedback? Crazy Franny Nixon.
Oh, hi, Crazy Franny Nixon.
She can't hear you. She's all the way down her house.
Type that back.
Yeah, I did.
Fez said hi.
Yeah.
Did you tell her? Yeah. She answered back?
She says she can't make it. I asked her just to call.
And she's crazy.
Yeah.
And she's not crazy enough to come.
I am not a retard.
I asked her just to call. She says, no, can't do it.
All right, fine. Well, it's just good hearing from Crazy Franny Nixon.
All right, we're talking about ways to annoy celebrities. That's a hobby Fez and I have. We see a lot of them in Manhattan, and we like to bug them when we see them. Not stalk them, not hurt them.
No.
Just say annoying things that they are going to be forced to remember you. Now, by saying it, you don't scream. You're not one of those crazy, heckling, maniac people.
No, there's no reason whatsoever to yell mean things at a celebrity. You can annoy through the art of, let's say, the backhanded compliment.
Right.
That's the key to the annoyance factor. Yeah. You have to sound like you're being nice.
Thank you very much, Fezzy. It's a positive, weird kind of a heckle.
So, you kind of give them that jab in the guise of a compliment.
All right, Rory, come on over here. Because I see you, and you look like you don't believe us.
Handsome Roy Hamptons.
Okay.
Rory, give us a celebrity.
Any celebrity whatsoever.
Mariah Carey.
Mariah Carey, perfect one.
All right, excellent.
Because you can see her on the streets of Manhattan.
Right.
Give us a little Mariah Carey music.
All right, can you do that for us?
To get us in the mood for it. And you have to picture, here comes Mariah Carey walking down the street. Fez and I are coming the other way. Perfect. We see Mariah. It's time to annoy her.
Right, exactly. So what you want to do is you pick out some of Mariah Carey's weaknesses that you know about.
Right.
Try to turn them into compliments.
Sure.
So, for example, you would see Mariah Carey and you go, you know, Mariah, I don't care what anyone else says. I love glitter.
Right.
That way you're being nice and you're saying, wait a minute, everyone else hated this film.
Or you say, hey, Mariah, did you see Beautiful Mind? You'd love it. That guy's crazy, too.
See? That way you're playing off her nut hut visit.
Hey, Mariah, have you met Tommy Mottola's new wife? She's so nice.
Oh, and pretty.
She's gorgeous and thin.
Oh, I love the new Mrs. Mottola.
She's perfect.
So you take the ex-husband jab. You say something like, so, Mariah, how exactly does it work? Did Virgin pay you $28 million not to sing for them or just not to sing at all?
That's good.
You get personal.
Say, hey, Mariah, now that you've been certified crazy, you still have to pay taxes?
Oh, good one. See?
That's, and that seems like you're happy.
Yeah, you let her know. What's it like to be crazy? It's got to be weird, huh?
Right.
Like you care. False caring is always a good way to annoy.
It's got to be weird.
Show false concern for the celebrity.
Hey, Mariah, what's exactly your deal? You black? You Spanish? What the hell's going on? Is it a mixture?
Is it both?
Is it a mulatto? Is it considered high yellow?
What's the deal?
If Spanish is in that...
Could you pick a race, maybe?
Right.
What do you write down on a job application?
Right.
See, curiosity. You want to know more about your idol.
Yeah.
You know, and just let them know, you know, maybe compliment other things that have nothing to do with them. Like, you know, I really miss your dad, Harry Carey, doing the Cub game.
Harry Carey was the Cubs win! Cubs win! And she's, you know, it's not my dad. Cubs win! You act like you don't hear.
What's Mariah Carey going to do when you're going, Cubs win!
Cubs win!
I loved your father, so.
Let's play three! And just screaming, let's play three at her. How about just congratulations on the Razzie? Way to go. And act like that. You didn't know that wasn't a good one. You did it again. You pulled it off. You got yourself a Razzie.
Well, look who's got a Razzie. It's right. You, Mariah Carey.
Yeah.
And they said you couldn't do it.
Mm-hmm.
See? You know, and you want to always, you know, be concerned for their health, too, but in a false way.
Right.
Like, you know, Mariah, you make sure you take your crazy people pills every day.
Got to take those.
You got to take your crazy people pills. It helped my uncle a lot.
Sure, you don't have to stay crazy.
Yeah, compare her to another nut.
Pills are good. Pills are good. Or you just give her that. You were great at the Super Bowl. I was so nervous. I expected you to freak out and start running around the field with your pants down. You didn't do it.
No, you just stood there and sang the national anthem.
Pills are good.
You didn't act like a nut bar at all.
Yeah.
Like everyone said you were going to. See, you compliment their work, but yet, how annoying are you? It's perfect. You know, you ask about her family. You know, yeah. If your mom still needs some dishes from the ones you broke, I'm having a yard sale this weekend. I'll try to set some plates, some plate servings aside.
They're non-breakables. Pills are good.
You're going to drive her nuts without being mean.
Mariah, do you even remember taking your top down in front of Carson Daly? I have the tape at home if you need it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You were whacked.
Pick out some of those key highlights of their lives.
Right.
That's how you annoy. You know, you say things like, I guess people still say you're going to be the next Whitney Houston. But that's not a good thing anymore, is it?
Mariah, you were the next Whitney Houston, weren't you?
Mm-hmm. Because she went kooky.
Camp Mariah, now, are those for retarded kids? Kids who break dishes? What happens there?
Right.
The chemical imbalance?
Yeah, ask about her charities. That's how it works there.
Yeah.
All right, now, you can actually kind of delve into her career a little bit. You know, you're not the same Carey who was the pet detective that made his butt talk.
Pills
are
good. Gotta take the pills.
Okay, here's the thing. You obviously know you're talking about Jim Carey. Mariah don't know you from Adam.
You were great in Pet Detective.
Excellent.
All right, and then you just give it this I'm so sorry thing. Like, if I thought, swear to God, I would have bet money would have been bigger than J-Lo.
Mm-hmm.
There's no way in the world I thought she'd be more successful than you. How does she do it?
I thought for sure I would have lost money on you.
Life is funny.
Yeah. Odd how things work out, isn't it? Mariah Carey. And then, you know, just kind of screw up one of her songs or something, and unintentionally. What did you mean in your song when you said, and then a hero comes along?
And then a hero comes along.
I swear that song makes me starving, Mariah, every time I hear it.
Right. So it's that simple.
Yeah.
That's all you got to do.
You actually kill with backhanded kindness.
Give us another one, Roy.
Roy, give us one more celebrity. We'll try this again.
He's not all
to show you.
This handsome Roy Hampton's not all that handsome anymore.
No, uh-uh.
The dew's coming off him pretty quick. Oh, by the way, I see this from Dan from Hoboken. Said he once saw Jay Moore and said, I loved you in Camp Wilder. And that was some bad sitcom that Jay had done. And Jay said, F you, and walked away. Why? What? Why? What? How many...
I said I loved you.
How many people do you think say to Paul McCartney a week, I guess there's no reunion now?
Oh, he must get that every single day.
You miss John.
John, then Linda, now George. Jeez. You're having a rough one, aren't you, Paul?
You're a carrier.
Yeah.
What is it, Roy? Don't just sit there staring at us. Give us a celebrity.
You've had 10 minutes. Did you pick out a celebrity?
I have.
Yeah.
All right, who?
How about Leonard Nimoy?
Oh.
Right, Leonard Nimoy's a good one.
Mr. Spock.
Yeah.
Yes.
All right.
All right, by the way, now here's a good one. When you say Mr. Spock, that's great. Pantera even writes in, one time he yelled Indy to Harrison Ford. So that's all you got to do, especially like if you're working and you go, like suppose you're in a hotel and you're give us some Star Trek music.
Okay.
You know, you're working at a hotel or something and you do, Mr. Spock, I've checked everything and I don't seem to have your reservations here. No,
our sensors indicate no reservations.
Nothing under First Officer Spock.
Try Nimoy.
Right. That's your other name.
Nimoy. That's Jewish, isn't it?
Nimoy. That's always good. Ask somebody if they're Jewish.
Right. Yeah.
Because even if they are, it annoys them.
Just speculate.
You seem Jewish to me, Leonard Nimoy. I always like the, Mr. Nimoy, I've read all your baby books. What should I do about teething?
I was Mr. Spock, not Dr. Spock. Thank you.
Uh-huh.
All right. But yeah, what about a colicky baby?
Or just go, Mr. Spock, mind meld with me, please, just once. Try and guess what I'm thinking.
Try to guess. I'm thinking of a number. Mind meld. See if it works. Me and my friends do this all the time.
Or just give them that standard, beam me up, Scotty. No intelligent life here, huh? Ha, ha, ha. How annoying would that be?
You know, he had that alcohol problem, so what you want to yell at him is, Mr. Spock, to the gym beam up.
Oh, well, I get you. That's good. Or, you know, act like you're into things and it's like, now the way I see it, the terrorists are like the Klingons. That's the basic case that we're in right now.
To try to compare Star Trek to today's political issues.
And people do it constantly to him.
I just, you know, let him know something personal out of your life. Man, I really got to hit the men's room and boldly go where every man's gone before.
Just something stupid to tie in, like he'll laugh, and of course he won't.
Right.
Or act like you know him and do it. Does Shatner really hate you?
Yeah.
Or Shatner comes off like a dick a lot of the time, huh?
That Shatner's a prick, huh?
I'm not going to discuss it with you, sir. He's just, I'm not going to talk over William Shatner with you.
Oh, you know, the guys who, you know he gets this, the guys who love his show, love his work, but take it a little too seriously and say, no, tell me, what's it like to be teleported? What's that feel
Does
like?
Does it hurt? I mean, all the cells are pulled apart.
You gotta be nervous.
Just look at him and say, aren't you dead? I thought I remembered the one movie you died in.
Just do the Scotty line at him.
Right.
You're already dead.
Oh, that's good. That's good. How about just give him the, I guess, Dr. McCoy's bones now, huh?
He really is bones, isn't he?
There's no way. Yeah. No way of getting around that one, is there? Dr. Spock.
Or with the Scotty thing, just say, oh, excuse me, are you wearing a watch? Because I need more time. Anytime you get to just yell in the man's face. As an homage. Not meanly, by the way.
Do that one again, because I think I like that one a lot.
Excuse me, do you have a watch, Mr. Nimoy? Because I need more time! That's what you want to do.
Just give him the, you know, with that Vulcan nerve grip. I guess nobody asked you for a back rub, huh? Seriously, could you knock me out?
Just try to get him to do those things. No, I bet it wouldn't work on me. Try it. I got big traps. Try it on me. I dare you.
Do the Scotty need more time thing.
Excuse me, Mr. Nimoy, do you have a watch? Because I need more time.
Or act like you and him are really a lot closer than you. You know, I bet a lot of your fans are real geeks, huh? By the way, could you sign my tricorder?
Yeah, try to separate yourself from the normal fans.
Right, that's the best thing.
That works.
That's the Rupert Pupkin angle. It's me and you against the weirdos.
Try to talk, you know, Vulcan philosophy with them. So I guess your people decided that the most logical haircut would be Moe's from the Three Stooges. That's the most logical haircut you came up with? Just that straight bangs thing?
That one I like a lot, though. And just...
You know, when you think about it, it really is logical. It's no muss, no fuss.
Yeah, it just stays there like Moe.
Right.
Seriously, what happened to those whales that you took to the future? Did everything work out there?
Are those whales okay? That's always nice.
On your planet, and even if you start with that on your planet, it's got to be scary. On your planet, are the Q-tips pointy to match your ears? What happens with that?
what do Vulcan Q-tips look like?
Pointy and green? Pointy and green, is that it?
I guess you could really just start working that word Vulcan.
Yeah.
Hey, I bet you meet some real Vulcan idiots, huh?
That's a cute one. I like that one a lot. All right, this on the instant feedback. Hey, Spock, still traveling to Uranus, searching for a Klingon? Thanks, Zach.
Sure, you want to annoy with the stuff that he's going to get every day.
Yeah. Jim. Jim's got one. Jim, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Jim.
Hey, how you doing, guys?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to ask him if he's still in search of his career.
Are you still in search of your own career?
Oh, because he hosted In Search Of.
Yeah. Which was a great show.
Work that into anything, you know? Can you help me? I'm in search of a place to take a leak.
Really got to take one. I guess we're in search of some chicks tonight, huh? Dr. Spock?
Yeah, nice place. I'm in search of a beer. How do you get one in this place?
I'm in search of a waitress if you see her come by, huh?
Let me know. I'm in search of a woman that's not going to take me for all I got.
He's just like, shoot me. Put the bullet in the gun, point it at my forehead, pull the trigger, kill me. All right, so that's fun stuff, is he?
Yeah, so that's how you annoy.
Annoying is important.
And then you just let him know that he's really old by saying, I guess at your age, it's live long and prostate exams, huh?
Ah, that's cute.
Try to make him do that thing with his hands.
Right.
That V-shape with his fingers. That I can only do on one hand. Can you... Ah, man, you can do both!
Everybody can do both.
Not me.
Hawk, do both.
I can't do... Oh, I can't be the only one that can't do both.
Rory, come in here.
I cannot make the Vulcan...
Al, come in here as well.
I can't do the Vulcan V-shape with both hands. I can only do it with
Everybody
my left.
Everybody can do it with both hands. It's impossible... It's impossible not to.
Oh, my gosh. Everybody's doing it.
Why wouldn't you be able to do that?
I can't make my... On my right hand, I can't make my ring finger match up with my pinky.
Are you...
Ow! It actually hurts.
Are you left-handed?
No. I'm right-handed.
Why wouldn't you be able to do whatever you want with your right hand?
Left hand, I got no problem whatsoever. Look, I can't make it go over there.
You
got
to work at it. Hawk, try to squeeze it apart for him.
All right, you hold them together for me.
Yeah.
The two won't go together.
You know what it is? It looks like your pinky.
Oh, that's the pinky that got broke. But I don't think I could do it before that.
I look how you can just stick your pinky out like that, though. That's...
Yeah, the pinky... I can do the three together, and the pinky sticks out. But I can't make the Vulcan V-shape on my right hand.
How can you not?
Oh, man.
Here's what I liked. You looked
I feel
at me.
Crippled.
You looked at me like I learned some kind of freakish trick.
Teach me.
I look around like, oh, everyone can do it. It's like asking if you can breathe or not.
I would have been perfect to play a part of an Earthling on Star Trek because they could never do it.
Oh, they couldn't?
Well, Dr. McCoy was always like, how do you do that?
Really? That's very bizarre.
Man, I'm going to have to do like a thing where I bind my fingers together until they learn to stay put. Now I'm obsessed.
Yeah, you should.
I have a new mania now.
What?
A new obsession.
Yeah. You know what? I honestly agree with you if you try the binding. Get some rubber bands and tie them tight around those two fingers.
So that they turn purple on the top.
We're not to leave them that long. It should only take a second. I've never met a person who... can't do that. Hey, Giovanni, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Giovanni.
Hey, guys.
Yeah.
Fez, I just want to let you know, when I was in school, I heard that if you couldn't make the Vulcan V-shape with your right hand, it means you're gay.
We said if it was if you watched too much Star Trek.
It's probably just as true. Hey,
Giovanni.
I never watched any of the Star Treks other than the first one.
I tried to watch this latest one.
Me too.
Enterprise. I bailed after the first episode.
I think I watched two episodes. And I faked that I liked it, but I didn't. I'm going, this is great.
They did it all wrong.
Yeah.
They did it completely wrong.
Yeah. Hey, Mark, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Mark.
What's up, guys?
Yeah, hold on. All right, we got the rubber bands. Tie them off for them. Tie off those two fingers. And you're going to... Tie them so they're tight.
So that they're together.
You never bound anything with a rubber band before? Go ahead, Mark.
Okay, well, you just do the Boy Scout thing with the first two fingers up.
Right.
And then you just, instead of bringing those other fingers straight up, you just kind of go outside with them. And then you can kind of...
There you go, when you bound them together. Now, does that feel normal to you?
Yeah, it feels good.
All right, so now that you can do it, just keep it out there.
All right.
Hawk, take off the rubber bands. This is so embarrassing. Take off the training bands.
They went back.
How could that happen? All right, put them back. Put it back.
Tightly.
All right, so just feel it out there, Fez.
All right.
Now keep it stretched. Pay attention.
Yeah, I'm trying to stretch it as far as I can.
Pay attention to the feeling in between.
Yeah.
The finger's okay.
I'm feeling a lot of tension there.
That's where it should be.
All right,
Hawk, now come over and take the rubber bands off.
And I'm holding it as hard as I can.
It's a little...
It's crooked.
Yeah, it's
crooked. Oh, look, the
it's
two...
It's closing in, too.
Yeah, the ring and the pinky, they're bending downwards instead of being straight up like the other two. They're bending down in front. Ow.
Hawk, let me see you do it next to him.
All right, Hawk.
Boy, Fez, you have a long middle finger for some reason.
Yeah, but look at my pinky. It looks like a popcorn shrimp.
Yeah, that one looks very small, like a hot dog, like a little...
Yeah,
but
a little Vienna sausage.
You know what? Maybe the middle finger may be just normal length and all the rest of it.
That could be.
Because it just looks like ballpark Franks where you should be having fingers.
All right. I'm trying really hard.
Yeah, it's starting to hit me on that.
Oh, now I'm getting lobster claws at this point. Turning into lobster claws.
Yeah, that's you. You'll be dating Billy before you know it. Maybe we can get her to come in for your birthday, Fez.
No. No. I don't want to go out for seafood.
For the seafood lover in you.
Weeble, you're the man for me.
Oh, Jesus.
As I cramp up my hands, I have to say, Weeble, you're the guy for me.
The show tomorrow you don't want to miss is Fez's birthday. This will be our last day. We're going to take a four-day weekend for Easter.
Oh, nice. We deserve and we need.
Nobody would ever say that. I deserve time off. Don't start any trouble.
No one else has any problem with it.
Well, they take weeks off around us. Tomorrow night is going to be a very, very cool time. We're giving away a pinball machine on the show with the tournament. How many shows do that, Fezzy?
None. Just us.
Probably because it's not going to be as entertaining as I think. But anyway, we'll try it.
Well, the tournament will be going on in the green room, and we'll give you updates of the brackets and everything as it advances to the finals.
Yeah, we'll have a chance to talk to all the people first, and then hopefully somebody will, at least one person will show up for Fez's birthday.
That would be nice.
Yeah.
That'd be nice. As we give away the Fireball Pinball Machine from ClassicPinball.com. ClassicPinball.com, your online source for anything and everything pinball.
That is going to be a lot of fun.
And we got our buddy Kevin coming in for ClassicPinball.com.
Also, I heard that Sheepy has made this.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Sheepy is going to be in the contest. He was one of the people who made it in. I don't see how he's going to be able to play pinball because he's too young.
So he's not going to know.
He didn't grow up in the age of pinball.
And he's just a really mean-spirited person.
Yeah, I know.
It's the problem.
Eight men. One machine. Tomorrow night, one man will finally settle the age-old battle of man versus machine. When all the flippers have stopped flipping and the bumpers stop bumping, one man will rise from the ashes as the victor. He will be crowned the champion over the Fireball pinball machine. In the end, there will be only one.
Wow.
Also, tomorrow, Fezzy.
Scary.
Yeah, it is. Only one. At the end. Tomorrow, believe it or not, is the last Sweet Melissa Moan. That means we ran it for a full 3 months. The longest promotion we ever did.
The only thing we've ever done consistently.
And I'm talking about in our entire radio career. We never, and I'm not making that up, am I, Fez?
No.
During our,
I wish you were.
Our entire radio career, we never ran a promotion as long as the Sweet Melissa Moan. Most of our promotions go 2 to 3 days, tops.
And then we tire or the staff just falls off.
Right. And even this time, as difficult as it was, we stayed in and... Hopefully we'll be able to talk to Sweet Melissa tomorrow night.
As we say goodbye to the Sweet Melissa moan of the night, your last chance to call in and win when you hear the Sweet Melissa moan.
And if you're in the mood for a batch right now, well, let's remember this classic one.
Oh, yes.
Hey, Roy, how many of those do you have saved up? It would be great if you could just grab a bunch of them and run them back to back to back tomorrow night.
Oh, that'd be cool.
Because, you know, we got 3 months of them saved up, Fezzy. We go out of this thing like it's 4th of July and we're just exploding.
The grand finale.
Yeah.
I probably have a good 30 of them, seriously.
Well, you should have a lot more than that.
We did it for 3 months, right? Yeah.
You should have a good 190 or whatever.
I'll go through it. I'm sure I have more.
Well, we have five a week for 12 weeks. We should have 60 of them, right?
Yeah. As many as you get. Put them all together.
Okay.
And let's see what they all sound like back. Look how the lines light up for that. No, we gave away the real one earlier tonight.
As we pull it away from them.
No, Mr. Mars Show, Pinball. Also, Fez's birthday and beautiful girl getting off. All on Run of Fez.
We'll be back tomorrow right after Opie and Anthony.
That Billy, get the hell out of here!
Don't mind him. He gets drunk, that's all.
Billy drinks around the house.
The person you're trying to reach is drunk.
I think Billy should would have a better chance assaulting.
You can't come popping in here. Gay as a cricket.
I'm gay. When I'm interested in one guy, if he doesn't pan out, I'll bang this guy.
I could have used a little more cowbell.
I'm working, Dan. I don't give the tongue at work.
I got a fever, and the only prescription is more cowbell.
We'll do it for John.
Stay gold.
I gotta have more cowbell.
No! Wait!
This must be awfully embarrassing for you. This is a goner.
No! Wait! I'm the one who says things.
Crazy.
Come on, say it along with us.
Ron.
No! Wait! I'm the one who says things.